Harold Robinson, just a freshman. He's number 27 on the top of your screen. And on the bottom is number 35, Timmy Lewis. This is Robinson. Across the 30-yard line to the 32. 17-yard return. Barsotti, the red-shirt freshman, will lead the way at quarterback. And in the backfield, Skipper and Myron Jones combined for 17 touchdowns this year. The wide receivers are small but very quick, Andre Alexander and Dwight Pickens. And the tight end is Craig Jones. His brother is the tight end for the San Francisco 49ers. Phil Lujan, Jeff Truchel are the tackles. Lujan, their best pass blocker. Paul Vial, the best run blocker. Skidmore has gone from the left side to the right offensive guard. And the center is Jim Radiman from Fair Oaks, California, a very good one. He has plenty of experience. Fresno State dressed in the visiting white uniforms, even though they're playing at home. Barsotti, you see the numbers. He's thrown more interceptions than touchdowns. He will throw it and go deep for Alexander, who makes the catch but drops the football at the 8-yard line. Barsotti had him, and Alexander simply could not hold on.
Alexander got open downfield. Once again, this running team for the Bulldogs faking the run to start the ball game. Barsotti rolling out, buying himself some time, and now here is this patented Bulldog bomb. They love to throw the ball deep, throw it about 45 yards. And it was right on the money. Alexander in double coverage that time, not able to bring the ball down.
Well, that kills our philosophy. We were told that they would establish the run from the very beginning.
And they will. Guarantee it. They will run the ball today, but you got to go on top sometimes to loosen the defense up.
So it's second down, 10 yards to go. Kelly Skipper, old nail behind the line of scrimmage. Sean Mulhern, big inside linebacker, number 61.
Eric Hoffman, number 63, tends to get all of the publicity for the linebacking corps for the Broncos. But Sean Mulhern, a fine, fine player, just a sophomore. All MAC academic player this year as he comes out of the ball game.
Well, defensively, they are very strong. Barsotti now faces a third down and 11. Alexander wide to the right side, Pickens to the left.
Behind the black line.
Showing blitz from the left side, and now they've taken too much time. So it'll be third down and 16. And this is taking the crowd out of the game.
It's also confusing Barsotti. You're going to see the Broncos all day long today move around trying to change up that secondary coverage, trying to change their alignment up front. They'll come up with 8 men at the line of scrimmage, 7 men at the line of scrimmage, sometimes 5, all trying to confuse young Mark Barsotti, the freshman quarterback out of Madera, California.
So now from the 26, and they'll run from the shotgun. Plenty of time. Now he has to scramble. Going deep again. Dwight Pickens comes back. Knocked out of the 25-yard line.
They were seeing a little jittery, little jitters right now on the part of Mark Barsotti. He's just not sure what he's seeing. And he scrambled out of there looking for Dwight Pickens deep. Certainly Pickens not his primary receiver. Barsotti would like to hit that back step and find probably Craig Jones. Couldn't find him. Now he just rears back and throws it as far as he can, hoping something good will happen. Perhaps a reception, perhaps a pass interference play. But the Broncos initially here doing a good job in taking away what Barsotti wants to do.
Defensive end Terry Crews on that pass rush went down. He just got up and came off the field. But we were visiting with their offensive coordinator, Rich Olson, today. He said, don't be concerned if we get off to a slow start because they show so many defensive fronts. Fresno State is stalling here, and they will have to punt it away. Lance Overparleiter to punt it away. At the 30-yard line. Paul Ajima, 45-yard punt, 2-yard return. And here's a look at Western Michigan's offense. Tony Kimbrough has had a spectacular year. Terry. He will have in the backfield with him main man Rob Davis, number 34. Excellent running back. Kimbrel will go with the one back set. That's 34 Davis. 12 touchdowns this year. And he'll flip-flop tight ends. Vernon Coakley getting the start. Pass downfield. Off the hand of Robert Oliver.
And right off the bat, we are going to see the deep passes all day. Davis, extremely quick. Fastest player on this Western Michigan ball club. He's one to watch out for.
And Alan Boyko and Robert Oliver are the wide receivers. The tackles are Haverdink and Vanderwill. That's the strength of this football team. Guards Eastman and Hutchins, and the center is Doug Miller. Second down, 10 yards to go for Kimbrel. Downfield again. Good coverage again. Harris, the free safety, came over. And now a flag will be thrown. And it was a late flag. Bowen's apparently the man who is interfering with the wide receiver for Western Michigan.
There's going to be some bumping going on in the secondary for Fresno today because of the fact they like to play man-to-man. And they're going to challenge downfield. A little bump there on the receiver. That's what the official saw. Ball was clearly overthrown, however. Wasn't a catchable pass, as the officials talk about it. We'll see how they're going to sort this one out.
Some boos from the Western Michigan side. Cheers from the Red Wave. Here's that defense. Ruggieroli, Willie Howard, he's 287 pounds. McCutcheon, the best nose guard in the Big West this year. And the linebackers, Rogers and Fountain, very fine. Rogers, of course, all Big West, honorable mention, All-American. Brian Greer is the middle linebacker. And those corners, James Williams, the best cover guy, Darrell Martin with Harrison Collins are the safeties. And, of course, the best blitzer on the team is Ron Cox, the rover back. He is on the near side of your screen. Let's see if he's blitzing on this third down. Yes, he is. Plenty of pressure on Kimbrel, and he throws the pass wide. A flag goes down to the offensive backfield.
Again, Fresno State doing what they wanted to do up front, and that is put pressure on Kimbrel, forcing him out of the pocket. But the Bulldogs are going to have to keep their eye on number 11. The penalty is going to go against Fresno State. They're going to have to keep their eyes on number 11 because he can scramble. He can run with the football.
On the defense. Repeat third down.
So we will do it again at the 35-yard line. Instead, it will be third down and five, and there is Al Moldy. What a great job he has done at Western Michigan, and it seems like the number one question in Kalamazoo is he leaving? That is not the case. He loves it at Western Michigan.
Well, they've given him some great opportunities there. He's turned his program around. That's what he does best, turning those programs around that have fallen on hard times.
And that's how rumors get started. Kimbrel, and look who is right in his face. Brian Greer, number 69, the middle linebacker, who's swept by offensive center Doug Miller.
We're talking track meet when this ball was snapped. Greer goes 225 pounds, and he is quick as a cat. He got through there almost before Kimbrel had the ball in his hands. That's the way you play defense. That's the way you disrupt the quarterback. Poor blocking scheme that time. Western Michigan center just did not pick up the play at all. Doug Miller not in position.
Bill Stein is there to punt it away, averaging about 35 yards a kick this year. And the man to return at 5'7", Andre Alexander. He'll have time to return, but calls the fourth fair catch. Inside the 25-yard line. After the 47-yard punt, we are scoreless.
The amazing Isuzu Trooper. It has a powerful fuel-injected engine, four-wheel drive, power steering, and four-wheel disc brakes, all standard. Yet it's over $1,000 less than Jeep Cherokee, Bronco 2, and S10 Blazer. And if you buy a Trooper now, we'll throw in this attractive car cover.
Act now and get a $750 factory rebate available on all Troopers, two or four door.
To get get great-looking hair, you don't need separate shampoo and conditioner. Get it together. In just one step, get your hair clean, more manageable.
There's one that does the work of two.
For control you can't get from shampoo alone.
Wash and go.
Shampoo plus conditioner in one.
Part plus.
I've got to go.
But we just got here.
I've got some calls to make. I'm going to look for another job.
What?
Our group's getting computers.
So?
So I haven't figured out the new typewriters yet.
Here's your chance to do a lot more than just typing.
Yeah, but...
Relax. Bob Dion learned how to use one.
Bob Dion? The guy who still needs help with the copy machine?
Yeah, that's the one.
Maybe I will have a little something.
The 1988 California Bowl is brought to you by Isuzu, the first car builders of Japan, and by Northwest Airlines, the airline that serves over 220 cities in 20 countries on three continents. Well, the Bulldogs have the football first and 10 at their own 23-yard line. And a look at Al Moldy. We were talking about going through the tough times. He says, hey, I remember being on the bus at Sioux Falls College saying, telling the bus driver to knock off with that smelly cigar. But he's now experiencing the great times at Western Michigan. Darryl Rosette off the right side. He has been a very effective running back this year, along with Kelly Skipper.
Not only a good running back is Rosette, he may be one of the best blockers that the Bulldogs have. Another one of those little guys, however. They list him at 5'11". If he's 5'11", I'm 6'7", and I'm not, folks.
Well, we're talking with Steve Rabel, the former wide receiver for the Seattle Seahawks. Craig Jones goes in motion. Skipper again. That's there. He's past the 30, not near the first down. He needs to get to the 33-yard line for the first down. Doug Krause on the tackle.
Well, when you think about running the football, for Fresno State, they tend to think toward the left side behind Paul Vial. He's the best run blocker. There you see cutting back, Skipper finding the hole back to the left side where oftentimes that crease will appear. For Western Michigan, they are going to have to get those linebackers in those creases and slow those running backs down, or Skipper and company will run for a lot of yards today.
Third and one. Jones again in motion. Skipper not there. Fourth down and two, he loses a yard. The tackle was Eric Hoffman, who averaged 16 tackles in league play this year.
This guy's very physical. He's not very big. He doesn't look like a big inside linebacker, but look at him find that opening and get through there to make the play. Somebody on the offensive line for Fresno State is going to have to get a helmet on that guy on every play. Otherwise, he's going to make 20 tackles out here this afternoon. He flows so well to the ball.
So an interesting start to this football game. Fresno State said they would run early, then pass. What they've done early is they passed early and then run on their second series. And Oberparleiter punts it well to Ajim, a 45 yards to the 25-yard line. And that means Tony Kimbrough will come out to quarterback.
You know, Steve, we've talked so much about Tony Kimbrough, the great athlete he is, the fine leader that he is on the field. He's a darn good person, too. Really nice person. He's spoken before all the big groups here during this Cow Bowl week, all the festivities. Everyone's been impressed with him. He's just a very fine guy.
And he's the guy who had to beat up David Cruz to start the year. Cruz led them to victory for Wisconsin. Kimbrough wants to go deep again as a man out there makes the catch near the 40-yard line. Alan Boyko. 34 yards.
Alan Boyko makes the catch, but it all starts at the line of scrimmage. If the quarterback has time, Ron Cox getting double-teamed there. He's getting blocked by Vanderweil and the running back stepping out to meet him. That's something that Al Moldy told us they were going to have to do is slow down Cox. Now they put two guys on him. That certainly helps, and it allows Kimbrough the chance to get that ball off and find Boyko down the sideline.
And that was over their best man cover, J.D. Williams. They sent Bruce Boyko in motion. He'll be the slot on the left side. And now go with an additional slot right side and Rob Davis. And they will fall offside as they blow the whistles before the play can develop.
Fresno State a little bit anxious in there, jumping into the neutral zone. You know,
know, sometimes that happens as a defense. When you just give up a big play, you're determined not to have that happen again. So you're maybe a little bit over-anxious. However, there's no excuse for especially the two inside linebackers and the nose tackle to jump off sides because they're the closest people to the ball besides the quarterback and center.
So it's a gain of five, Steve. It will be first and five after the penalty from the 36-yard line. Still waiting for Rob Davis to carry that football. He had 1,000 yards rushing this year. He will get it this time. And he's near a first down. Rob Davis loves, he says he's coming home. This is California. He played his high school football in Los Angeles and had back-to-back 1,000-yard rushing seasons in high school. And then he had a hip pointer last year, held under 500 yards rushing. Second down, they need two. Garnett Fountain and Brian Greer are the middle linebackers, and they're looking to plug those gaps, but Kimbrel will throw instead. He has pressure from the outside and throws the ball away. So it's third and two.
And that time, look for number 54 in the white shirt, Ron Cox, coming off the far side. Once again, this time try to single block him with the back. Can't do it. Even the tackle slides over, tries to make the play. Cox can fight through both of them. Folks, we're talking about a guy here who is one fine defensive football player because he's got all the tools. He's fast, he's big, he's strong, he can tackle, and he's got good football sense. And what's best of all about a defensive player, he's got a mean streak.
Jim Sweeney was telling us yesterday that there's one guy on the team I would hate to have mad at me, it is Ron Cox. He's 18 going on 28. He's a sophomore. Kimbrel again downfield. Has a man open, but it's incomplete. So it's fourth down and two. And now the question, will they bring on John Creek for a long field goal? Yes, they will.
Kimbrough that time a little bit disappointed in that he did not get that ball to Boyko. He's got him down the sidelines in man-to-man coverage, but you got to give your receiver a chance to throw it. You got to put a little more air under it, and that's exactly what Al Moldy's telling him. Put a little more arc on that ball. It'll drop down. Give your receiver a chance to catch it.
So here's John Creek from 50 yards out to try and give the Broncos the first lead of the game. And he did not get it. He slipped on the grass. And we should tell you now that Fresno State's field people planted ryegrass, which is a little more slippery than Bermuda.
Jim Sweeney told us yesterday, he said, I'm a little bit nervous. This is home field, and I don't know if my guys are going to be able to handle it. Take a look at Creek. Can't even plant his foot.
We have a scoreless ball game with 9:34 left.
12:42 p.m. entering Toyota dealership.
Hi. Hey, you're Joey Suzu.
Hey, guys, it's Joey Suzu.
My kids love you.
Come on, what's the real difference between your Corolla and my iMark?
For starters, the Corolla's about $1,000 more.
Oh, what a feeling!
Joe, you're not going to use that in a commercial, are you?
Oh, no!
With $500 factory cash rebates, the Isuzu iMark saves you up to $1,500 over Corolla.
You just got a frequent flyer award, huh?
That's right.
You don't fly frequently.
No, infrequently.
How can you be a frequent flyer if you don't fly frequently?
How can I hit the ball if you're talking
to me? How can
you
hit the ball if you're going to be talking over there?
On Northwest, you don't have to fly a lot to earn a free trip fast.
Have you ever seen those commercials where one battery outlasts the rest? We'd just like you to know Energizer batteries were never invited to their playoffs. A word to the wise, Energize.
Fancy perfumey aftershave. It's got to be a quarterback's locker.
Real guys who get mud on their uniforms use rugged, honest stuff. Ice Blue Aqua Velva.
There's something about today's Aqua Velva, man.
Look for Aqua Velva Christmas gift sets.
Before you even touch this camera, you're going to want to own it. The incredible 35mm Infinity Super Zoom 300. New from Olympus.
Jim Sweeney's defenses have usually been dominant in the first quarter, 101-20 in this first period. But here they've been stuck by the Western Michigan defensive side, and how by number 89, Joel Svenge.
Smenge and Hoffman, the two top tacklers, the two top defensive players for Al Mulde's ball club. And again, neither of them are very big, not what you'd think as far as defensive stuffers, but they're tough. They flow to the ball well, both up very quick, legitimate 4-6, 4-7 sprinters. With that kind of speed, you can get to a lot of plays.
Second down, 9. DeBreeze goes in motion with Craig Jones. And Barsotti in trouble, has it slipped off the hands of Myron Jones.
Once again, Barsotti finding himself on his back as he tries to release it. He's a one, maybe two read quarterback. He'll look for his initial receiver. If he can't find him, maybe look to a secondary receiver if he has time. But he hasn't got the experience to look through three, perhaps even four receivers and try to find the open guy or try to find the man who's getting single coverage. That's his problem so far today.
Well, if DeBreeze goes in motion with Jones, that means you're playing man. Well, here's Barsotti, and he will be sacked. And it was Smenge. There are many who feel he's the best linebacker on this team, not Eric Hoffman. Now, he plays a down defensive end and an up linebacker on occasion, but they'll switch him all over the place.
All these defensive players for Western Michigan can move around, play different positions. A hold against Fresno State now as the ball gets moved back. But take a look at Barsotti when he gets back, and he's going to look downfield. As a quarterback, you've got to concentrate and know that your receivers are going to get there. But you cannot throw the pass when you've got a guy drilling you from behind. Jeff Truchel, the tackle for Fresno State, just no match speed-wise for Smenge.
And they will turn down. They'll take the sack, and Olga Parleiter is out once again. He's boomed it well. One was a 2-yard return. The other was a fair catch. We have 8 minutes and 36 seconds to play in this first quarter of a scoreless game. This one is a line drive. Ajima has a chance, and now it takes a high hop. And will be down by Fresno State at the 37-yard line. 37-yard punt by Overparlay. So Kimbrough gets the instructions from Coach Al Mulde. And races out to set his offense.
You know, the way these two teams prepared all week, I think it's kind of indicative of the two coaches. Sweeney, as you talked about before, Steve, kind of loud and boisterous and a real motivating type. Mulde very quietly has come in here, prepared his team. He knows what works for Western Michigan. So far today, they've done an excellent job in throttling both the offense and defense of the Bulldogs.
So Kimbrough now with a first down. Davis trying the middle. Gain of maybe one. McCutcheon there for the tackle.
And I don't think Western Michigan is going to fool anybody by running the football. Rod Davis will carry the ball occasionally on a draw play, perhaps a little sweep play, but just to keep everybody honest. He did pick up some good yardage during the course of the season, but this is a passing team primarily. And when he does pick up big yardage in games, it's because teams are so content to try to throttle that pass that they leave the middle open for the run.
Fresno State showing the blitz. Kimbrough is racing away from it. Almost has his pass intercepted by Tony Harris. Big West free safety, and he is a good one.
He's a big one, too. 6'3", 205. This guy will hit you like a linebacker, but quick enough to cover not only tight ends, but wide receivers as well. Here he's on his horse. Kimbrough with the strong arm. That ball was destined to be caught. Harris gets that hand up and knocks it down. Again, man-to-man coverage. Fresno State loves to play it. They may get burned once in a while, but more times than not, they'll make big plays.
Watch the bottom of your screen. That's where 54 Ron Cox is. You know he'll be coming this time. He's the outside rover back, and he blitzes about every opportunity. Here he comes. Here comes Rogers from the other side. In the face of Kimbrough, the pass is... It is incomplete at the 30-yard line, almost held on to by Alan Boyko. He was fighting Marquez Pope, the freshman safety, step for step at the 30-yard line.
Again, another nice pass by Kimbrough. This one, however, I think this was a little ill-advised. We're talking double coverage downfield. Kimbrough trying to fire that ball in there before the safety has a chance to get over. And number 7 for Fresno State, very nearly, Craig Bowens, very nearly makes that play, makes the interception.
And let me correct that. That was Robert Oliver who was the intended receiver. Stein with a nice punt here. Alexander from the 18. He is very quick, and he's finally cut down near the 24-yard line. 44 yards in the punt, a 6-yard return. We've got 7:26 to play in this first quarter of a scoreless game.
$89?
For a Honda? That's fantastic! We can drive a new Honda?
For $89?
We're going to Putnam Wind.
Get your new 1989 Honda for only $89. That's right. $89 down delivers an 89 Honda. Hurry to Putnam Wind Auto Center in Visalia.
I bet you thought Santa probably has the best decorated house for the holidays. But even Santa has help from Martin's. At Martin's Silk and Dry Flowers, holiday decor is one of our specialties. From cordial entertaining to your memorable holiday dinners. With Martin Silk and Dry decorations and gifts, your Christmas can be enjoyed for years to come. Visit Martin's today and make your home a Martin's home. Martin's with two locations in Fresno and Visalia.
With this lie detector, I'll prove this great-looking Isuzu is a better pickup than Toyota. It has more standard features than Toyota. It has a double-walled cargo bed, steel-belted radials, and a 5-speed transmission. Toyota doesn't. Yet it's priced hundreds less than Toyota. See? You can trust me.
Act now and save even more with a $500 factory cash rebate on any Isuzu pickup.
There's Patty Anderson, the 1988 California Bowl queen. She says, hook 'em horns.
Hi, Betty. I think she was waving at me, Steve. I'm not sure.
Doubt it. No way. Fresno State, first down. They're on 23-yard line. Jones again in motion. Now they're in the zone. And Skipper, no, this is Rosette trying the middle. He gets 2 yards to the 25-yard line. It will be second down and 8. But again, that interior there, that means Kraus and Hoffman and Manier.
We've talked so much all week. We've heard so much about the offense for Western Michigan. Jim Sweeney says to his guys in the sidelines, hey, this is a great defensive football team, and we are going to stick to what we do best, but somebody's got to come up and make a play here once in a while. Somebody's got to break a run or make a catch.
Barsotti on the option, drops it on the floor, and it will be covered by Western Michigan.
Fresno State wants to get outside. They want to run on occasion, and they will run the option at times to try to mess up the defense. This time they messed themselves up. Watch Barsotti. He's not necessarily an option quarterback. You have to practice this. Bad pitch. Way behind is running back Daryl Rosette. The ball stays on the ground. Western Michigan falls on it. Going the other way. The short field they have to work with now. Looking to the end zone.
The turnovers. Right now, costing Fresno State. The Broncos have the football on the 24-yard line, the second time they've been inside Bulldog territory. Kimbrough has time. Completes the pass at the 15-yard line. It should be a first down.
What a great catch. Stay sitting for just a second. It's Robert Oliver. Go ahead and stay down there. Catch your breath here a little bit. What a shot he took, but what a great catch and concentration. Kimbrough waits, finally finds his receiver, and look at that dart he throws. Now, Oliver covers up. He takes a shot, lands right on his head, but hangs on to the football.
Well, they cannot afford to lose him. Their best receiver, Jamie Hentz, is downstairs in the radio booth because he tore a knee earlier this year. A fabulous receiver. Oliver's to his feet and will be helped off the field. They've got a good backup for him in David Bell, and he will come on the field now wearing number 43.
But without Oliver in the game, he is their fastest receiver now that Hentz, as you mentioned, is injured with the knee.
At the 13-yard line. Double slot. Davis will pick up Ron Cox, and Kimbrough fires, completes it. 5-yard line, run out of bounds by Craig Bourne. But another good gain of 8 yards. Ajima on the catch.
This is just a good man-to-man route by Ajima. This guy, Ajima, is so underrated. Watch him, the inside receiver. He's going to go in, then come right back out again, trying to take Craig Bowens with him. Craig Bowens may be the most suspect in that secondary as far as man coverage is concerned. He's basically a free safety. He will draw Ajima much today. That will be a good matchup.
Dan Bogan is in the game, and Oliver's back in the game, so he's all right. He went out wide left as a wide receiver. Now the officials will stop the play, and we will have our first measurement. We have 6 minutes and 16 seconds left in this first quarter, and we are scoreless. Fresno State nothing, and Western Michigan nothing.
Steve, this should be real no surprise to us that Western Michigan is playing so well here. We've talked about the home field advantage for Fresno State. This Western Michigan team, they have won on the road all season long. They are 5-1 on the road this year. They don't mind going into somebody else's home stadium and playing. All they want to do, again, is play their brand of football, and Moldy has drilled that into them. It's a confident passing game led by Tony Kimbrough, pure and simple.
They had three important games back to back to back. Eastern Michigan, Central Michigan, and Ball State. And the final one, Ball State, they won on the road in an absolute mud bowl. It's first and goal from the 3-yard line. Double tight end. Davis, oh my, he's shut down to the 4-yard line. Maybe a loss on the play. Ruggieroli, Daryl Martin.
And Tracy Rogers, number 45, in there as well. Rogers stuffing things at the line of scrimmage. The blocker has no place to go. Bogan cannot find any crease to get up into to lead his running back. Davis is flat on his back.
A loss of one. Second and goal from the 4. See if Kimbo goes through the air. Still showing double tight end. Here comes Harris. A fumble. Fresno State has it. Rogers recovers. They blitz the 3 safety, number 4 in the play, Rabel, and that really created it.
You can't block everybody. You don't have enough people up here, but sometimes a quarterback has to account for that man. But even Tony Kimbrough, as good a QB as he is, does not have eyes in the back of his head. He can't see Craig Bowens coming. Great call by the defensive coaches for Fresno State. Nice job there. Kimbrough coughs up the ball, and Fresno State now, they get an opportunity to turn and go back the other way.
Al Moldy said his biggest concern was Fresno State's defensive team speed. We saw it there. Now they'll run the pro set. Quick 3-step drop, complete pass. Dwight Pickens out of bounds, and that is his first completion in the game. It's 12 yards and a first down.
Dwight Pickens, a favorite target for Barsotti all season long. He's the deep guy. He's the sprinter. Alexander, number 1, likes to go across the middle, more the possession type guy.
Let's attack a few more on.
Take a look one more time at this fumble. Look at 4. Number 4 comes untouched off the corner. Kimbrough doesn't have a chance. Never sees him coming, and the arm is not moving forward, so there was no incomplete pass there. It was a fumble. Tracy Rogers, who was always around the football, falls on it for Fresno State.
Well, Pickens gets 12 on the reception, 15 more on the personal foul, and Fresno State with a first down at their own 45. They pick up the blitz. Barsotti wants to go deep. Alexander is there. Makes the catch. Touchdown!
Barsotti finally finding the range. Number 1. Andre Alexander. Now watch. Barsotti sets himself and lets her rip. And Alexander just runs past the cornerback, Paul Davis, falling down, trying to make the play. Alexander kind of not complaining this week, but just letting it be known that he would have liked to see the ball a few more times this season, as would Pickens. But because Fresno State went to that running game, they were kind of shut down just a little bit. Not in this Cow Bowl, however, as Alexander puts him on the board.
And Steve Luke with the point after. It's perfect, and it's 7-0 Fresno State. Alexander's second touchdown of the year, and it goes for 55 yards.
Take a look at Andre Alexander. Not very big, but lots of speed. Not a lot of move here. He's just going to try to run by on the post. Got to keep up. defensive back, Bert Henderson, makes the dive, can't stay. Touchdown, Fresno State.
You know, he went to San Francisco City College and was one of the great players there, averaged 25 yards per punt return. Came here last year. They were thinking about redshirting him this year because they thought he wasn't mature enough. But he came back over the summer and they said, hey, this is a different guy.
Redshirting has been very successful for Fresno State. They've got a lot of guys. I mean, they've got some athletes coming up that are redshirted now that will keep this team in good athletes for years to come. But when you got a guy like Andre Alexander and a quarterback like Barsotti, you've got to use the personnel that you have. You can't save them forever. Get them on the field and let them help you now.
So Steve Loop comes on to kick off for the first time in this game. Fresno State won the toss to start the ball game and received that football. Oh, the turnover. Western Michigan was at the 3-yard line, fumbled, and Fresno State has taken it the distance to take the lead. I know it's a cliche now, and they say the team that makes the fewest mistakes is going to win, but it always seems to be true.
Amazing how that happens, isn't it?
Good kick by Luke. 5-yard line. Nice return by Western Michigan out near the 27. 23-yard return.
Alan Boyko, who does just about everything on this Western Michigan ball club. He's even played quarterback and defensive back. But when you've got somebody that's that versatile, you've got to find a place for him. And in this case, for Western Michigan, he catches passes, returns kicks.
And if you hear us saying the name Boyko a lot, it's because there's another one on the team, his twin brother Bruce. Bruce plays the tight end. Allen plays a slot in a wide receiver spot. And as Steve indicated, a little bit of every place. Rob Davis tried to reverse his field, nothing there. McCutcheon is there for the stop, and a flag is thrown. Scoring drive after the fumble, 82 yards in two plays. The reception to Pickens, a penalty tacked on, and then up top to Andre Alexander.
Again, a little bit different for Fresno State this year because they have been grinding it out on the ground much of the year. They like to run that ball with their two running backs. But then that oftentimes opens up that passing game for you, especially that deep pass, as Alexander showed.
We had a grabbing the face mask. It was not intentional, so it would just be a 5-yard walk-off. First down and 5 from the 32.5-yard line. Alan Boyko is wide right. Double slot left side with Davis, the lone setback. Kimbrough wanting to throw. Knocked down at the 35-yard line. Brian Greer with a left hand.
Brian Greer has made his presence known out there today. He's been all over the field. Take a look at that. Got the big neck collar on back there. Looks like his head is resting right in the middle of his chest, doesn't it?
Well, he's made a great recovery. He was lost in the Washington State game, the opener on the first play last year. Brian Greer came back from a serious knee injury, and he is starting the entire season.
Oh, boy. That looks like a gorilla, doesn't he, with that neck? And you put that neck collar on it.
And interestingly, he started the year with fully wearing a size 13 shirt.
Sure he did.
Kimbrough on second down. Incomplete, and there's a reason for it. Garnett Fountain was in his face.
We talked about pressuring Kimbrough. That time, Garnett Fountain. They'll just take turns, Fresno State. They don't rebuild in this school. They reload. They have new people coming up all the time. And Garnett Fountain, the senior, playing perhaps his best football this season. Sometimes has a tendency to get a little bit lax. Will maybe sit out a play or two. Then they'll bring him back in the game. And he'll make big plays as he just did.
He stays in the game here. And Kimbrough really struggling. Third down and 5. Complete Davis, first down, and just barely as he stumbled to the 38-yard line.
When you're going man-to-man, as Fresno State is doing much of today, one of the best matchups you can hope for is to get a guy like Davis out of the backfield and being man-covered by a linebacker. That time, the little swing pass successful. Had he not fallen down, he may have picked up another 10, 12 yards.
Instead, he just barely gets that first down. like man coverage for Fresno State. Playing a deep free safety is Craig Bowens. Davis, I believe there's movement. Either on the offensive side or...
I think Ruggeroli jumped into the neutral zone that time. Again, you know, defensive lineman, he's got his hand down. He's looking at the ball, waiting for the snap. I know you're tense. You're like a bulldog pulling on a chain, but you got to hang in there, wait for that ball to be snapped.
And Jim Sweeney is a couple of yards out on the football field shouting at his defense. Hey, not too eager.
Sweeney's the kind of coach. He's a great guy. He's the kind of coach that during the week he will give his assistants the opportunity to coach. They will put in the game plan. They will do the teaching. But on game day, this is Jim Sweeney's team.
And their total offense has done the job for Western Michigan. Al Moldy has gone into a MAC conference that likes to run the football, and he has aired it out. He's been a major difference in this program. Decimated a couple of years ago. Kimbrough's arm was hit. It is an incomplete pass to the 40-yard line, and it will be second down and five.
Willie Howard putting the pressure on that time from Fresno State. You talk about Western Michigan's offense, you're right, setting all kinds of records back there in the MAC conference, but they haven't seen a defense as aggressive as Fresno State's this year. Take a look. Haverdink, the tackle, he just cannot keep Cox out of the backfield. Cox that time just getting a hand on the ball as Kimbrough had it cocked, ready to throw. That's what Ron Cox, that's what great speed will do for you.
Steve Rabel said at the beginning of the ball game, the keys would be the outside backers of the offensive tackles. And again, Garnett Fountain comes blitzing, and the pass by Kimbrough is over the head. So another incompletion for Tony Kimbrough, and a guy who completed better than 55% of his passes this year is struggling through the air.
Well, again, he's seeing that pressure. He's seeing those man coverages downfield, and those receivers have got to get away. They're getting bumped outside. They're forcing Kimbrough to wait a half a second longer before he throws that football. That's difficult for him. He's used to throwing on timing.
4 of 14 through the air for 61 yards. It's a 7-0 ball game. Fresno State has the lead. Jeff White comes in the game. He will pick up the slot man on the right side. Davis going in motion, and now we have the illegal motion.
Fresno State jumping off again. Now they're going to point to Western Michigan. I think this one's going to go back against Fresno. Let's see. Offsides once again. Al Moldy says, yeah, Kimbrough's doing a good job with that snap count. Jim Sweeney on the far sideline saying, come on, guys, hang in there.
Now, Kimbrough will check off like 70% of the time, so he has to really know what the defense is giving him, and Fresno State will cross it up so much.
Well, that's why Fresno State has been offsides three times. They keep jumping in there trying to confuse the audible calls, and now Kimbrough saying, I don't like anything that I see here. Let's come to the sidelines and talk about it.
And he calls timeout with 3 minutes and 38 seconds left in this first quarter. Fresno State is leading 7-0 on Andre Alexander's 55-yard touchdown. That is a new Cal Bowl record. And we have NFL game day coming your way tomorrow right here on ESPN. They've got Chris Berman and everybody else, all pro linebacker Tom Jackson, who used to knock Steve Rabel around. And they'll be giving it all to us 11:30 Eastern time. And of course, NFL primetime. And that will be a heck of a ball game. Steve Rabel, you'll be there. Right. Call it as well for Seattle Radio.
Right up there in great Seattle, Washington, my hometown now, or my city for 13 years. Love that city. Great football game, great tradition between those two teams in the AFC West. And you're right, Tom Jackson has cleaned my clock on a number of occasions. I hope he's listening right now.
That's part of the Fresno State band. They call them the Red Wave. They've sold out every game this year. This stadium holds 30,000, and they've averaged 33.5. That is saying a lot for the San Joaquin Valley area.
They sell spots on the grass, the hillside here. There's no seat on part of the stadium. There will be eventually. But right now, they just sell the open grass areas for folks to come up, sit down, and enjoy the game.
Tony Kimbrough faces a first down and 10 after he called that timeout. Bulldogs showing a six-man defensive front. Now he's checking off now. Kim Kimbrough in trouble, sidearms it, completes the pass to Ajima, and I don't know how Kimbrough was able to do that.
Well, I'll tell you how great athletic ability for one, because he didn't get a whole lot of help. Pressured by Nick Ruggeroli that time. Kimbrough looking for the quick pass, forced to pull it down because you know who was in his face, number 54, Ron Cox. Jeff White, who is an excellent man-to-man cover guy in the secondary, a backup defensive back out of Oxnard, California, right there on the play.
So Kimbrough, after the gain of four, has a second and six situation. Brian Greer really flip-flopping as the inside linebacker. Davis reads it well, fights his way forward for a couple of yards near the 45-yard line.
Not a whole lot there on the run for Rob Davis. That's what makes his Fresno State defense so good. I mean, they're good enough athletes that they can pressure that quarterback and still stop in midstream turn and catch that running back who's just been slipped the ball on the handoff of the draw.
So now Kimbrough needs four for the first down. An eight-man front. The blitz from the left side, Rogers, and the pass overthrown again. Boy, that has to really be a difficult time. You can't even get into a three-step drop before the pressure is there.
But Western Michigan is going to have to do just that. They're going to have to depend on the quick drop and then to get rid of the football. Kimbrough saying, hey, you know, I've got to throw the ball high because I got Cox right in my face. I don't know what I'm going to do. Ron Cox is so big and strong that every time I turn around, he's right there in my way.
And Cliff Heisel, who's the defensive coordinator for Fresno State, said, we have to first stop the draw. We have not seen the draw in the first quarter. Stein boots it to Alexander, calls for the fair catch, and takes it at the 15-yard line. 31 yards of the punt. It will be Fresno State's football. They own a 7-0 lead, and Andre Alexander has been the star thus far in a 55-yard touchdown. Well, the offensive comparison is very similar, except for the way they get it done.
Sure, both teams averaging over 400 yards of total offense on the season. Both have winning records. However, you look at what used to be known as Wide Receiver University, they're putting 230-plus yards on the board on the ground, whereas 260 yards for Western Michigan through the air.
Barsotti back to the I formation. Straight drop. All kinds of time. Wants to go deep again. Again, it's Alexander. And it is intercepted at the 30-yard line. Cole Davis. And that is his fourth interception of the year.
Davis, one of the true freshmen on this Western Michigan ball club. Barsotti with the good fake that time. Lots of time because of the fake. And here he just throws it deep. But because he waited so long for the receiver to get downfield, it allowed the other defensive back to get there, the safety, Davis, right on the play. And he just makes a great interception.
What a crazy game this is. We say keys to victory. Establish the run for Fresno State. They come out and throw it deep four times in the first quarter.
And one time successfully, one time now intercepted, and the other one's knocked down.
Kimbrough completes the pass. The bounce, 38-yard line. Alan Boyko. Now they're going back to that, what, three-step drop?
The quickest thing that they can do, and that is get rid of that ball in a hurry. Just get the quarterback out from underneath the center. Tell those receivers to get separation from the cornerbacks as quickly as they can, either quick outs or quick slants, and let's establish something on offense. That's what Al Moldy's saying on the sidelines.
Well, he needs 3 yards for the first down now on second down. Well, Ajima is the running back. Now he moves to the slot. Kimbrough in trouble again. Greer loses him, and the pass is complete to Ajima for the first down. They needed to get to the 42. They got to the 43, and Kimbrough's getting it done with two straight completions.
Kimbrough finding his old teammate at Grand Rapids Junior College. Those guys playing a little pitch and catch. Here now the matchup that we've been watching for much of the day today. Here's Haverdink, the tackle, in the dark jersey, number 74, doing a good job controlling Tracy Rogers, the big outside linebacker for Fresno State. Guy who's leading the way on this team in tackles and has 10 sacks on the season.
He's listed at 6'2", 250. Al Mulde does not believe that. He says he's a good 235, maybe 238. At 250, I was expecting to see a huge human being. Azima to the outside, good run, up across the 45-yard line, a gain of three, maybe four.
Remember early on we talked about Kevin Haverdink and the problems that he's had this season, broke a fibula. Take a look at what he's wearing. Haverdink, number 74, the dark jersey, the offensive tackle in that huddle. You can barely see the leg through there. Those are the knee braces, first of all. Now, look at that, protecting that shin.
He
lugged that thing around the whole game.
He came back after 2 weeks off with a broken leg to play college football, and even goes first team All-Mac. That is a great story. Rob Davis in the game now. Kimbrough with a little time, incomplete, and Davis was wide open and had plenty of running room with his 4-4 speed.
A good pick that time by Western Michigan, and this is something that the Fresno State coaches were worried about. You send somebody inside to pick off the man who's covering the running back, and that allowed Davis to run free toward the sidelines. Had the ball been on the money, this is what we talk about. When you get somebody open, you've got to make it count, because Fresno State doesn't make many mistakes on defense.
And it would have been one-on-one against only one man, Darryl Martin, and Davis has the much better speed. So it's third down, seven to go. Kimbrough, here's the rush. There's the incompletion, fourth down, and on comes Bill Stein to punt it away.
Now looking to his former teammate, Paul Ajima, just a little bit behind him, and Ajima slapping his hand saying, you know what, I think I should have had that one. Kimbrough said, yeah, I believe you should have.
Kimbrough has only been sacked one time in the game. Well, you've got to go with two because of Tony Harris messing him up for the fumble, and Rogers got him the other time.
But he's been under so much pressure, and even if you can't sack the quarterback, by pressuring him, by getting hands in his face, that's going to cause him problems.
Stein, J.D. Williams almost blocked it. He's knocked down six this year, and that was a 25-yard punt.
And J.D. Williams is a great story coming off the corner in blocking kicks, or trying to block kicks. As you said, six blocks on the year, a couple of interceptions. And look at him hurry now. Maybe this is not JD. No, it's number eight. It's Jeff White. And an excellent effort there. Again, another defensive back. Great speed, 4-4 speed coming off that corner.
Boy, if he doesn't angle that off the side of his foot, it may have been into White's hands. This is Adrian Cooks off the right side. Gain of two to the 30-yard line. Cooks, he is a junior from Atascadero, California. And here's a look at that defense. Western Michigan hit you with, and they are a good one. They go with an eight-man front. They will flip-flop around, go with one outside linebacker and two inside linebackers. Why?
Well, again, trying to get the kind of matchups that they're looking for, and also stop teams that like to run the ball.
That's the end of the first period. 7-0 Fresno State. Barsotti throwing that touchdown pass to Andre Alexander of 55 yards.
Could it be any colder in here?
It's not that bad.
No, I just saw my breath in the kids' room.
Come on.
Admit it. We need a furnace we can actually afford to run. You know, like an Amana.
Amana?
It's reliable and efficient, so we can afford to keep the whole house warm. You won't get the Amana for me, then get it for the kids.
I've never heard the kids complain.
Good night, Daddy.
That's not fair.
When you know exactly what you want, Amana.
Snow, incredible snow.
Oh, our sight, huh?
It's our first trip to America's premier ski resort.
Hey, what do you think?
Black, huh?
Yeah. I can see you working the main lodge tonight there in the romantic glow of a roaring fire. Your danger takes its toll.
Dandruff. Tis the season for the flakes that don't melt.
I shampoo every morning.
Shampoo till spring with an ordinary shampoo. Won't work like this.
You use Head and Shoulders. You don't have dandruff.
Nothing gets by you, does it?
Head and Shoulders, because you never get a second chance to make a first impression.
First, my dog ran away. So to cheer myself up, I bought an expensive TV, and it came with a remote. Then my girlfriend left me, so I bought a VCR, and it came with a remote. Then I was transferred to the Yukon Territory, and it came with a remote. Then I was audited by the IRS, and they came with remotes. So to simplify my life, I bought a Memorex CP8 Universal Remote, which could do everything eight different remotes could do. Then I was happy. In fact, the happiest cold and lonely guy stuck in the Yukon without a dog.
Nature's light. bathing fields of grain, enriching full fresh hops, giving life to sparkling streams, nourishing all the natural things that go into making Bud Light. The light beer that's beechwood aged for a clean, fresh taste that makes Bud Light the one light that outshines them all.
It's Bowl Week on ESPN. The All-American Bowl featuring the Florida Gators against the Fighting Illini. The SeaWorld Holiday Bowl with Heisman Trophy winner Barry Sanders leading Oklahoma State against high-scoring WAC champion Wyoming. And the Mazda Gator Bowl, a showdown between Georgia and Michigan State in the only bowl game on New Year's Day. It's a bowl bonanza, live on ESPN.
Fresno State leading Western Michigan 7-0, and Western Michigan saying one of the things they wanted to do in this game was to confuse the redshirt freshman Mark Barsotti. They have not done that thus far. It looks like Barsotti a little more confident. And here we go on second down. This is Darryl Rossette. Tries to get outside. It is not there. And Hoffman was there again for the stop.
Rossette, another one of these quick, small Fresno State backs who Jim Sweeney likes to get the ball to. They say they want to own the draw here at Fresno State because, again, that allows them the opportunity of throwing that football, keeping the defense off guard. They want to own the sweep as well. Get those quick scat back types outside around the corner.
And now they face a third down and about 7 yards to go. Barsotti is hit, and the pass is almost intercepted. Will they call it an interception? No, they will not. The man celebrating was Scott Lonier. But I was waiting for the official to come through with a final call, and he finally did and said incomplete pass.
Yeah, he trapped that. When he got his hands on it, ball was not well thrown by Barsotti. He's going to look inside now for his tight end. And there you can see it low. Good play by Lonier, as a matter of fact, making a break on that ball. Jones jumps up screaming, hey, there's no interception there.
So Oberparleiter on again. Fresno State leading 7-0. Here's the rush. Ajima calling for a fair catch out of bounds at the 30-yard line. A 39-yard punt by Oberparleiter. But the job that he has done is he has refused Western Michigan to return that football.
Now, we showed just a moment ago before we started the last series with Fresno State the ineptitude offensively for Western Michigan today, their inability to control that pass rush. They've got minus 11 yards on offense. They've really had a difficult time here today. Kimbrough has got to get this offense together now and try to complete some of these short passes. And I think, frankly, mix in that run a little bit more. Give that ball to Davis and try to keep these guys from Fresno State off balance.
Rob Davis has rarely carried the football. Four times for just 5 yards. He moves into the slot, so it looks like a passing situation. Now Kimbrough says, no, I need you back there. Because that's the reason I'm going to give you the football. This is Ajima, and he's out of bounds. A gain of maybe 2-3 yards. It was Ajima who he was telling where to go.
Again, probably an audible. Kimbrough will audible 65-75% of the time up at the line of scrimmage. And they want to try to take advantage of the matchups that they can get. Try to get that ball to that back, get a big guy on a linebacker blocking, and move him out.
Second down 8. Look at that Fresno State defense. In the middle is number 90, Chuck McCutcheon, flanking him is 235-pound Nick Ruggieroli and 287-pound Willie Howard.
And our pause here is the officials are asking the Western Michigan players and especially Coach Al Mulde to get back off the field. So they held up action here for just a bit till Mulde could get the signal in. You don't see many head coaches signaling in the offensive plays, but Mulde does it here for the Broncos.
Second and 8. Kimbrough dumps it off. Draco on the catch. He has the first down at the 43-yard line.
Take a look at the block by Doug Miller on this screen, and this is an excellent call. When people are rushing you, slide your back through there a little bit, find him. Bruce Boyko's the man, number 30. Now watch 69 coming in on the righty screen. Boom! Holy smoke! Knock him down. He earned his money on that one, and his guy doesn't even get paid to play the game. What a great block by Doug Miller.
Gain of 11, and now the Red Wave fans are on their feet. Long pull by Kimbrough. He's checking off. Wants to throw. It's complete. Out of bounds. 48-yard line. Darrell Martin, the coverage.
What Kimbrough read that time was single coverage, but he saw number 41 for Fresno State, Darrell Martin, backed off just a little bit, giving Oliver a little room on the sidelines to work, and Oliver just went down, ran a little five-yard turnout route, and it was wide open. That's the way Western Michigan can move this football down the field. They can't be greedy. They got to take what the defense is going to give them.
They give them five this time, and Oliver goes wide right. Aja moves to the slot on the right side. Kimbrough's in trouble. Throws the incompletion to Ageman, and again, he was wide open. So Kimbrough's doing a nice job of checking off. He's calling the right plays.
He is. They're just not executing well. Kimbrough has got to lay that ball, that little pass out there to Ageman. He's just got to flip it out. Watch number 69 in the white jersey in the center of your screen. We see pressure on the quarterback right here. But he was picked. He was supposed to be. That was Brian Greer, was supposed to be covering Ageman out of the backfield. He was picked. Ageman was wide open. Kimbrough couldn't get the ball to him. Two times now, they can't complete that pass.
Third down and five. Incomplete this time. Ageman can't hold on. And a flag is thrown after the play.
Western Michigan is getting exactly what they want, Steve. They're getting a quick receiver in Ageman coming out of the backfield or out of that slot position. And they're matching him up on a linebacker, either Greer, that time it was Garnett Fountain, but they're unable to complete the pass.
Well, here you've got a penalty on the play, and it was holding against the offense.
So even had they completed it, it doesn't count. But finally, Kimbrough has an opportunity to throw, has an opening to step up and pass that football, and he just can't hit his receiver on that quick out. That's going to be the bread and butter for this team, and they're going to have to find a way to make that play work. Al Moldy's telling him the same thing. Be patient and just get the ball to that back out of the back.
Fresno State turns down the penalty. Bill Stein comes on again. As long as 48, but he's had a couple of returns by Andre Alexander. Now Fresno State, well, we've got a flag down. Alexander again with the fair catch at the 20-yard line. They may take it back even further. 33 yards in the punt. Let's listen to Jack Baker, referee representing the Western Athletic Conference.
We have a holding on the defense administered from the end of the run.
All right, 13-10 left in the first half.
A couple times I wondered, why'd you get yourself into McManus? And then it all kind of came together.
There's no telling what you can do.
Okay, McManus. Go.
Especially when you have somebody who really believes you can do it.
Be all that you can.
The amazing Isuzu Trooper. It has a powerful fuel-injected engine, four-wheel drive, power steering, and four-wheel disc brakes, all standard. Yet it's over $1,000 less than Jeep Cherokee, Bronco 2, and S10 Blazer. And if you buy a Trooper now, we'll throw in this attractive car cover.
Act now and get a $750 factory rebate available on all Troopers 2 or 4-door.
Announcing a dramatic breakthrough in shaving technology. The new Remington Microscreen Ultimate shaves as close as a blade and closer than any other electric shaver, or your money back. The Ultimate's exclusive beard lifter gets whiskers other shavers leave behind. And like all Remington Microscreen shavers, the first screen shaves incredibly close, the second even closer. Try the new Remington Ultimate now. It will shave you as close as a blade and closer than any other electric shaver or your money back.
Broncos have brought their fans from Kalamazoo. 7-0 Fresno State, though. And the 1988 California Bowl is brought to you by the U.S. Army. Learn how to get an edge on life. Be all you can be. And by Isuzu, the first car builders of Japan. There's that red wave that was sold at every home game this year. Bulldogs' only touchdown came on a 55-yard pass from Barsotti to Andre Alexander. So here we go, and Jones will switch tight end positions.
And Myron Jones, the fullback, carrying the football that time. He, great speed does Myron Jones have. He just doesn't seem to be utilized quite enough, whether it's because they don't feel confident in giving him the football, but he doesn't seem to make the big plays that everybody expects him to make.
Well, he has been criticized by the offensive coaches for not being consistent. Very fine talent, but when he's blocking that football, he's a different player. This time he's off and running, and he's finally cut down from behind past the 40-yard line. And they said when he carries a football, his attention is there. When he has to block, he's a little different player.
Just when we say that maybe he doesn't always do what he needs to do, here he cuts back across the crease, and now look at the nice job, runs out of the tackle right there. That's just a great effort on his part. A 29-yard run by Myron Jones out of Chatsworth, California.
Another junior college transfer from Fresno State. Try the middle this time by Adrian Cooks, and he has a short gain across the 45-yard line.
We talked about it the other day, Stephen. The great specialty players, the great skilled position players that we have on this field today, a quarterback and receiver, just like any other football game, this thing's going to be won up on the line of scrimmage. The affectionately known as the Hogs, the big guys up front, the offensive and defensive linemen, they are the guys that control a football game, pure and simple.
Jim Sweeney thought at the beginning of this year they were much more advanced as run-blocking line than they were pass-blocking, and they proved it this year. Complete to Jones. First down. He's out of bounds inside Western Michigan territory.
Jones had just a sensational spring drill, and coming into the season early on, really kind of tapered off, forced Sweeney to go away from him a little bit more, although he did lead the team in rushing yardage, over 670 yards, and averaging nearly 6 yards a carry when he does get the ball. But he'll also make a play, not so good one time, and then the big play the next time. What they'd love to see out of him is a little more consistency.
Well, he is the fullback, and now he will break from that fullback position and operate as an off back to the right side. Stephen Shelley goes in motion. Barsotti to throw. Downfield. Man open. Caught by Stephen Shelley.
Barsotti starting to find that range a little bit. After the 55-yard touchdown pass earlier, he hadn't done too much. Here, the 25-yard completion to Shelley, lots of time. Isn't it amazing how well a quarterback throws when he gets a little bit of time to throw? And there's a great catch. I love watching receivers make catches like that. Wonder if it's because I never did. Anyway, Stephen Shelley, great reception, 6 foot, 180-pound junior, and this guy can fly as well.
There's a timeout on the field, and Steve Rabel was talking about his receiving ability. There's a reason Steve Largent had that consecutive games catching passes. That's because Rabel was taking the free safety out of the picture.
Sure.
Rabel was the receiver on the opposite side. There you see Barsotti joining number 12, Eric Bouchel, whose older brother, Steve Bouchel, plays for the Texas Rangers. And number 17 was last year's starter, Dave Telford. Interesting story. He threw for 536 yards in one game, threw 70 passes in one game, and he's not starting this year.
Yeah, Telford is a great story. I mean, he comes out of my part of the country up there, Camano Island, Washington, and a great high school football player. And everybody figured he was going to be the starter this year after the season he finished up with last year. But Barsotti gives the Fresno State football team a great effort as far as running the ball. He's a good mobile quarterback.
Now on Western Michigan side, they had plenty who made the All-MAC team. Kimbrell, Hoffman, Berrios, Haverding, Oliver, and Smenji. Fresno State is inside the 20-yard line at the 19.
All those first-team players, and that really is a tribute to this Western Michigan ball club, who this their winningest season. They had never won the MAC conference outright, so this has just all the way around been a great year for them.
Jones, tight end right. On the reverse, Alexander read beautifully. Paul DeVries, oh, what a play he made from his left outside linebacker spot.
And you want to take a guess who made that call on the far sidelines? Jim Sweeney's offensive coaches, not necessarily inclined to go with the gadget plays very often, but every so often, Coach Sweeney will say, I'm going to run it. I'm the head coach. He probably made this call on the far side, and he may regret it. Who knows? But when it works, he looks like a genius, right? Sometimes they don't always work, but they're down in good field position right here. Why not take a shot at it?
But he did say he will blame that on the offensive coaches.
That's right.
Garsotti needs 14. Intercepted. The second interception of Garsotti in the game. Sean Mulhern.
Garsotti taking a lot of time back there. Again, trying to look from his primary receiver to his secondary receiver. Look at him. He's got lots of time. Now he has to get rid of it, and when he double clutches it, he pulls the string on it and throws it over his intended receiver. Mulhern picks it off.
12:42 p.m. entering Toyota dealership.
Hi. Hey, you're Joey Suzu. Hey, guys, it's Joey Suzu.
My kids love you.
Come on, what's the real difference between your Corolla and my iMart?
For starters, the Corolla's about $1,000 more.
Oh, what a feeling!
Joe, you're not going to use that in the commercial, are you?
Oh, no!
With $500 factory cash rebates, the Isuzu iMart saves you up to $1,500 over Corolla.
What's up, Big Johnny?
Clean, crisp taste of Beechwood-aged Budweiser.
Hey, man. Good job.
You the best.
Hey.
Oh, thanks for that.
Send up a cross foot. Give me an app check.
There's a place in the friendly skies where not everyone's so friendly.
Stop. Hold it. I need 3 hours minimum.
Check it out. Over 9,000 mechanics of United Airlines work
here. Give me a mini grinder.
They're picky, fussy, stubborn. But if you fly, they're the best friends you'll ever have. United, rededicated to giving you the service you deserve. Come fly the friendly skies.
So you want to be a quarterback, huh? Take a look at what Mark Barsotti goes through right here as he drops back to throw the big right-hander looking downfield. One guy's covered, looks again, boom. Terry Crews takes him to the ground. Sure, it's a glamorous position, friends.
He's only a redshirt freshman. Maybe next year he wouldn't throw that pass. He'd just eat it. Instead, he has an interception because he has a fine field goal kicker in Steve Luke. They're showing blitz, and they're bringing the blitz. And Kimbrough wants to go deep. It's incomplete. Tony has been stymied, but the reason is because he's had five, six people in his face. Oliver was the intended receiver.
Tony Kimbrough has got to learn how to put some touch on this football. He's got such a strong arm, but I don't care how good a quarterback you are, when you've got coverage like this and Darryl Martin, number 41, running right with the intended receiver, that's just great coverage, and you've got to throw the ball absolutely perfectly to even have a hope of having that one.
There's a Western Michigan defense talking with their coaches, trying to slow down this Fresno State team that leads 7-0 with 10:30 to play in this half. The pressure on. Kimbrough with that escapability, and he's out of bounds. It'll be third down and long.
Now that's something that Fresno State was really concerned about, and really the first time today that we've seen Kimbrough pull it down and take off. And he may have to do this more. Look at the guys coming upfield. And here comes Ron Cox, number 54. He chases down the quarterback, Kimbrough. Kimbrough could probably play defensive back or running back in major college football because he's that kind of athlete. Ron Cox chases him down from behind.
Well, he was recruited by a lot of Big Eight schools and by Michigan State to play defensive back, but Kimbrough wanted to
to play quarterback, and that's why he went to Al Mulde in Western Michigan. Looks downfield, incomplete. It's fourth down. Bill Stein must come on again.
Kimbrough threw that ball a little high, and Alan Boyko wanted absolutely nothing to do with it.
10 minutes, 21 seconds remaining in this first half. Fresno State scoring on a 55-yard pass from Mark Barsotti to Andre Alexander. That is a Cal Bowl record, breaking the 1985 record by Kevin Sweeney to Gene Taylor and their 53-yard touchdown toss. Sweeney is now playing for the Dallas Cowboys. Taylor for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And we may have running into the kicker here, but they say now they'll throw the flag. It looked like the referee had a difficult time getting it out of his pocket.
Well, it was a late flag, and I thought, quite frankly, that Jeff White was blocked into the kicker. The official calls it, though. Let's take a look at this one more time. If you, as the rushing man on the punt, are blocked into the kicker, that should not be a penalty. Look, Stein has trouble getting that ball away. He lets it get to his chest. That's the first problem. Now, there's the block. I think he's blocked into the kicker. He's not taking a great angle to block the kick in the first place, talking about Jeff White in the white jersey. But look now, as the personal protector pushes him right into the kicker, I don't think there's any question. He's been blocked into Stein. Now the official has just waved it off. He says the ball was touched. So there is no flag on the play. If the ball is touched, there's no block.
So why do they drop the flag? He took so long to pull it out of his pocket and throw it on the ground. What was the call?
Well, they said right there that White was able to get a hand on it. Obviously, the official on the other side of the kicker who made the call did not see that the ball was tipped. But clearly, from our standpoint, he was blocked into the kicker, so it shouldn't have been a penalty in the first place.
And Al Mulde saying, hey, wait a second. What's going on? I want an explanation here.
Yeah, Mulde says, I want to look at the replay. Well, we don't have replays in college, Al. Sorry about that. Now he brings his entire defense over to the sidelines, and they want to talk it over.
And we've got 10-14 left in the first half. Fresno State up by 7. Good call, Steve.
Hunting season is here, and so are the bugs and mosquitoes. See Herb Bowers for Benz 100 insect repellent in aerosol or cream. Benz 100 is the most powerful and effective insect repellent on the market. Deer hunters, stock up on the famous line of Foggy Mountain scents and lures. Improve your chances of bringing home that buck. Pick up Foggy Mountain Hot Doe Buck Lure and be sure to cover your scent with Pro Cover. Benz 100 and Foggy Mountain products are available now at Herb Bowers Sporting Goods.
It's time to let my son take over, so I'm retiring to do some fishing. But first, I'm selling my entire inventory of personally selected fine jewelry at Fresno's best values, up to 60% off the original price.
Here's two of many great buys. This 18-inch strand of fine cultured pearls, regularly $11.75, now only $5.87. And dozens of tennis bracelets, 1 to 12 carats, retirement sale price from just $1,900 to $19,500. Plus, we welcome all major credit cards, Christmas layaways, and extended budget payment plans.
Only at Prince Orloff & Son Jewelers, Fig Garden Village, Fresno.
One thing that a guard does not want to do when a quarterback sets short, you have to protect your inside shoulder.
Mike Patrick and Joe Theismann, ESPN's All-Pro team, bring you NFL excitement when the Broncos and Seahawks battle for the division title on NFL Sunday Night Football, live on ESPN.
Take a look now. The original call by the official was running into the kicker. Here comes Jeff White off the left corner of your screen. He's blocked into the kicker, but now watch the ball sail off to the right. The ball is blocked at that point. The official could not see it blocked originally. Stein takes a little too much time. Ball is tipped right there. Kicker is run into, but he's blocked into the kicker. I don't think a flag should have been thrown in the first place, but at least another official downfield saw that the ball had been tipped, and they give the ball over to Fresno State. No penalty call.
So we've had 4 turnovers in the game. Fresno State has been intercepted twice. This is a block punt and also the fumble. Barsotti going for the bootleg, and it's read beautifully by Smenge. This guy plays like Ted Hendricks. He's 6'6", 225, and not only does he bring down Barsotti, but he takes off his left shoe.
This guy's forced 6 fumbles on the year, too, so he knows how to reach in and grab that ball away from there. He's just not fooled by the naked boot. That's something else at Fresno State and Jim Sweeney like to do. Roll that quarterback, fake the pitch, and just send him out there with the ball on his hip. That time, Smenge was not buying at all. I'm very impressed at how well prepared this Western Michigan football team is. They are just not letting anything get past them other than a great pass and catch by Alexander in the first quarter.
Well, Barsotti calls time to tie his shoes. And he is our student of the game as well. It's brought to you by the U.S. Army. Learn how you can get an edge on life. Be all you can be. Mark Barsotti is the student of the game. He's got a 3-3 in business administration here at Fresno State. A redshirt freshman from nearby Madera, California, just down the road, where he threw for over 4,000 yards and 52 touchdowns, coached by Dennis Fink.
You know, they talk here in Fresno in reverential terms of Kevin Sweeney. Jim Sweeney's son, the quarterback, of course, who set all the records here and now with the Dallas Cowboys. But this Mark Barsotti actually has more physical ability than Kevin Sweeney does. He's bigger, has a better throwing arm, is a better runner than Kevin Sweeney. Kevin Sweeney could win football games for you, but Barsotti can be a great, great quarterback here at Fresno State.
Well, he loses 9 on the bootleg. And that play was probably called by Jim Sweeney.
He won't admit to it, but it probably was.
Well, he told us yesterday that he likes the bootleg in certain situations. That may have been one of them. This time, Craig Jones goes from the left side to the right side tight end. Western Michigan showing the blitz. Barsotti checking off. Here comes the blitz, and here comes the deep pass. Alexander out there. Touchdown! His second of the game! He caught one touchdown throughout the regular season, and he has 2 already in this game.
Try to confuse the young quarterback, and sometimes you confuse yourself. Great play. Alexander just runs away from the coverage. That time, Scott Bell, he was beaten by 3 steps downfield, the defensive back from Detroit, a junior walk-on. No chance against Andre Alexander, and a great pass by Mark Barsotti.
And Loop adds the point after touchdown. You know, Fresno State throws a different kind of deep pass. They throw it almost straight up in the air. It's a real timing pass, a 5-step drop, and tell me the rest of it.
Steve, they call it the bulldog bomb. They try to throw it for about the 45-yard range, right about in there, get some loft on the ball to allow the receiver to run under it. That's exactly what they tell Barsotti. Put something on it, give it some arc, and just let your speed guys outside go for it. Look at Alexander. I mean, he just ran right by the coverage that time. Barsotti going to what he does best, and that is just let her rip.
You know, it looked like when the defensive back is going back to try and, they're having a difficult time finding the ball.
Well, and that could be a problem for them as well. I personally look, as I see the coverage there, it looked like the cornerback was playing backed off a little bit, and he expected to get help from inside, from the safety, and that help never got there. He was so far behind the receiver. Alexander didn't make that big of a move, so I think there was some sort of blown coverage there. Again, you try to confuse the young quarterback, you may confuse yourself in the process.
So Barsotti has thrown for 2 interceptions, but also 2 touchdowns. And Fresno State has a 14-0 lead. And here's the return. Out to the 30-yard line. Alan Boyko, 22 yards in the return. Steve Loop races off the field. Not a very big guy. He started his career at California and didn't think he was going to start. Went to a junior college, and here he is at Fresno State.
Bulldogs have done a good job, as we talked about a few moments ago, redshirting certain players. They also do a good job getting them out of junior college. Here's the storyline on the game today. Really, the story for Western Michigan is getting almost nothing going offensively, and this man has got to change that right now, number 11.
Uh-oh. Rob Davis, first down near midfield. They'll say no, it is not a fumble. His knees were down. The field, the ground cannot cause a fumble.
And did Davis explode through that hole in the line or what? That may be the first time all day we've seen any kind of gap in that Fresno State defense. And Rob Davis taking advantage of it with his 4-4 speed. Look at the blocking. A little counter tray blocking right there, pulling the guard and tackle from left to right. And Davis just follows right behind his big offensive lineman, picks up big yards.
He has the first down. 49-yard line. Doug Miller is a big center, and Kimbrough wants to throw. Ooh, incomplete. Again, he has the man he wants. He's open, but he's a little bit too much on it.
He finds his slot back slash tight end, Bruce Boyko, the twin brother of Allen. He just can't get him the ball. Again, the way you play against a man-to-man coverage is to run crossing routes, pick routes, try to run away from the secondary. And he's getting his guys outside where he wants them. Kimbrough just can't get the ball to him.
He's thrown 27 passes, completed only 9 for just 93 yards. And he's a gentleman who's averaged well over 240 yards passing this year per game. Davis is the lone setback. This is 2nd and 10. And Davis gets the call, and he's cut down. 3 white jerseys there, led by Chuck McCutcheon and Tracy Rogers. Well, it's been the Alexander story. He's caught a 55-yard touchdown pass, a 38-yard touchdown pass, and 2 plays, a 37-second drive.
Both drives for Fresno State, short 2-play drives. Nice. So, obviously, Fresno State, knowing offensively, they don't want to take a chance on taking this long time to put the ball in the air. They want to just get those points on the board, get inside at halftime with the lead.
Kimbrough now with a 3rd and 14. Comes Cox, pass thrown, complete, first down, and knocked out of bounds, Bruce Boyko. Tony Harris was the man who knocked him out of bounds, but Coach Al Mulde was telling us yesterday, when they've had big plays this year, it's usually been number 30 who's come up with it.
Boyko, perhaps the most underrated player on this team. Everybody talks about Kimbrough. They talk about Davis' speed. But Bruce Boyko out of Hamilton, Ontario, just a junior. Good receiver, catches just about everything that gets close to him. Not all that fast, but is fast enough to run away from people, as we just saw Tony Harris having to chase him down, push him out of bounds.
23-yard gain, 1st and 10. Fresno State going over their straight defensive set. Brian Greer showing blitz, now dropping off, and here in the face of Kimbrough, and that was a timing pass, and Ajima turned his head just as the pass arrived in his hands.
Pressure once again on Kimbrough, and it's got to be discouraging for number 83, Paul Ajima, because they're so used to running these timing routes, and the timing is so messed up today because of Fresno State's offense. Or Fresno State's defense, putting pressure on Kimbrough and rerouting those receivers downfield. A couple of the keys that we talked about early in the ballgame.
2nd and 10. Western Michigan needs to get just across Fresno State's 22 for a first down. There it is, and Kimbrough down the field, catch is made, and it is a touchdown! That almost looked like steer wrestling, trying to get that doggy down, and he couldn't do it.
Kimbrough called the audible because he saw what is known in Fresno State as the bulldog defense, an all-out blitz coming, man-to-man coverage downfield. You've got to take your shot. Darryl Martin, the cornerback, number 41 for Fresno State, just not able to keep up with the speed of Robert Oliver on that post pattern.
So Western Michigan comes alive, and John Creek with the point after, and the Broncos back in the game. It's a 14-7 contest. Tony Kimbrough trying to get his team fired up, and he's doing it himself.
He's telling everybody that we know that we can do it, and Robert Oliver, his quick wide receiver outside, who averaged 20 yards a catch this season. Look at him make the nice little head and shoulder move outside, jumps inside. Darryl Martin is beaten already. He doesn't have help inside. You've got to get a hand on him out there, Darryl, at the cornerback. Now he tries to bulldog him down. No way. Robert Oliver smells that end zone. He wants six.
You know, you said before the football game that Fresno State had to reroute the receivers. Martin didn't even get a hand on him that time.
And that's the key. If you want to reroute somebody, you obviously have to push him. Give him a little shove. Don't let them back inside when you have absolutely no help in the deep middle of the field. Bill Martin just misplayed at that time, and it cost him.
So the lead cut in half. John Creek, who has already broken the school record in extra points. It's an old record, too. We'll kick off from the 35. Fresno State with an excellent return team. This will be Robinson. On the return, this is Dwight Pickens. He has excellent speed, turns the corner. Another play called by head coach Jim Sweeney.
Well, they're going to pull them all out for the California Bowl, aren't they? Every play that they have stashed in the back of the playbook. Pickens is going to get it on the reverse. He thinks he should have taken it for more yardage downfield. Got a couple of great blocks. We'll see it once again on the replay. Watch the handoff. Coming back. And this is dangerous back here because now you've already lost 10 yards on your kickoff return. But a guy with speed, make that corner. One block and he can turn it upfield. Doesn't get it. He's tackled.
Barsotti starts his offense from the 31-yard line. He's going deep again. This is Anthony Williams, but it's over his head. Williams had a step on his defenders, Paul Johnson. Brian Johnson one and Paul Davis the other.
Took Western Michigan six plays and 70 yards before Kimbrough found Oliver with that 32-yard touchdown pass. And that is how Western Michigan did it this season. Scoring passes aplenty to a lot of different receivers, too. Western Michigan has moved that, spread that ball around to six different receivers over the course of the year.
Barsotti has Pickens left, Alexander right. Again, he looks deep, and this time he'll be sacked, and a flag goes down, and that may be holding. He's right in front of Jeff Truschell.
You know, as an offensive lineman, if you're going to hold, you can at least protect your quarterback a little better than that. If you're going to get hit with a flag, make sure that your quarterback doesn't get hit as well. Barsotti had no chance at all to get rid of that.
Our officials are from the Western Athletic Conference and from the Pac-10. Three from the WAC, four from the Pac-10.
Holding on the offense. Penalty is declined. Third down.
And they want the sack. So it's third down in a bundle. In line is Truschell, Langham, Radiman, Viol, Lujan. It's interesting how we talk about them after a sack. This guy's saying, hey, that's not fair. Timing pass, Craig Jones. Did he hang on? I believe he did for the first down. Boy, he juggled it. And then he was surrounded by brown and gold jerseys. And Jones is slow in getting up. 25 yards in the catch.
He took a nasty shot. Had he been able to catch this ball and hang on to it and tuck it away, then he can prepare himself for the hit. But when you're in this position as a receiver, watch. The ball is a little bit high. Jones makes the catch, but now he juggles it a bit. And oh, my, does he take a shot right on the headgear. And that stings, friends, knowing from personal. Oh, boy.
He hung onto the football, though.
It sure looks as though he did. Now, we saw the ball lying beside him, but after he was already down, Western Michigan coaches to the near sideline saying, no way, that ball popped out of there. Craig Jones, I think, right now isn't sure what happened. He just took a wicked shot right to the head.
He had one of the best catches this year against San Jose State.
With this lie detector, I'll prove this great-looking Isuzu is a better pickup than Toyota. It has more standard features than Toyota. It has a double-walled cargo bed, steel-belted radials, and a five-speed transmission. Toyota doesn't. Yet it's priced hundreds less than Toyota. See? You can trust me.
Act now and save even more with a $500 factory cash rebate on any Isuzu pickup.
Roger, sometimes I wish you were a fish.
Coast, the scent opens your eyes.
spirits start to rise. Coast is the way to make you feel alive.
Roger. Want to go to the park?
Coast, feel alive with Coast.
America was built on dreams, and business is the key.
The officials have changed their decision. They ruled it an incompletion by Craig Jones. Now, we're working with a split crew, a lot of guys who haven't worked together in the past, but they changed their mind after they regrouped during the timeout and said Jones did not catch the football. So Olga Parlotti will punt it away. And it is taken at the 44-yard line just barely by Ajima. 30 yards in the punt, not a good one by Overparlighter.
Ajima makes a good decision to come up and catch that ball. Had it bounced, it could have gone behind him another 20 yards. However, dangerous because he started to stumble and fell to the ground. Luckily hung on. Let's take a look at the touchdown reception one more time. Tony Kimbrough finally putting the Western Michigan Broncos on the board. Number 11, the quarterback. And let's see what he sees as he pumps, looks downfield, throws the post route. Do I have it? Do I have it? Do I have it? Yes, sir, you bet. He's not even... Now we got a touchdown signal. All right, Tony.
He was waiting for him to carry himself in the end zone. That was Robert Oliver on the touchdown catch, and we've got somebody moving.
In front, Ray Fonseca, the offensive guard, jumps to a set position. Western Michigan. Now, the play just a moment ago. Barsotti looking for his tight end, Jones. Here's the catch, sort of. He's bobbling the ball, and now he takes a shot. An elbow, as a matter of fact, to the head. Ball, you see it roll out there. Officials called it no catch. Incomplete.
Kimbrough down the field. Oh, and dropping the pass right in his arms is Rob Davis. You know, they don't throw to Davis that often. 8 catches this year for just 56 yards. Maybe that's why.
Perhaps. You've got to take advantage of what limited opportunities you're getting. Chuck Knox, who I've heard talk a number of occasions, talks about game plans and all those things. And we've talked theories and game plans out here today. But he says, above and beyond all that, football players make the plays. And when you're open, you have to make that catch. And you have to pass that football and get the completion as the quarterback if you want to win the game.
Chuck Knox, the Seattle Seahawks, will be taking on the Denver Broncos right here on ESPN tomorrow night. That should be a good game. It's second down, and 15 after the penalty, and Tony Kimbrough doesn't like the way the defense looked, and he's taking a timeout, and now a flag is thrown.
Flag is thrown.
Well, Kimbrough apparently never got the call from the official. He called timeout and backed his guys away, but the official never saw him. They're out of timeouts.
Well, when you burn your timeouts with 7 minutes left to go in the first half, mainly because you can't decide what you want to call, that's not too good.
Well, one official didn't catch it, and then the other said, hey, wait a second. I've got 3 used up already. So here we go from the 34-yard line. And that means Fresno State will be sending everybody. Well, they back off now. They can go with a straight 3-man rush. They show blitz, and the pass is incomplete. It's 3rd and 20. Robert Oliver, again, the intended receiver. Now they're changing up a little bit. They're dropping back.
Well, they don't want to get beat deep on this kind of situation here. You know, you've got to keep the receivers in front of you. Again, man coverage. Oh, look at the push off there. That's an offensive pass interference right there. There should be a flag on the play.
Well,
Robert Oliver doing a nice job just literally pushing Daryl Martin away from it.
He got the payback when he dropped the football.
Well, that's right.
3rd and 20. Number 4 is Tony Harris on the inside. He's showing blitz. He's the free safety. Here he comes. But he's picked up nicely by Western Michigan. And they're going deep. Boyko, it's interference against Fresno State. James Williams.
And J.D. can't believe it. He's shaking his head saying, oh, man, you have got to be kidding me. Running stride for stride downfield. Kimbrough is just going to let this one loose.
On the defense, 15-yard penalty. First down.
With the catch is Boyko. Officials say J.D. Williams, the best man-to-man cover guy on this Fresno State team, interfered. Western Michigan is going to get out of their own territory here just about.
So instead of 4th and 20, it's 1st down, 49-yard line. Both these teams have been penalized a lot this year. And there's the Irishman, Jim Sweeney. Done such a terrific job in putting Fresno State on the football map. One of the winningest programs on the West Coast in the 1980s. Davis, he escaped to the outside. Rob Davis could go. It's a touchdown, and Western Michigan is within one of Fresno State. Another by Robert Oliver, and now number 34, Rob Davis.
Davis just waited in the hole long enough for his tackle, Kevin Haverdink, to push away one of the Fresno State defenders, open up that hole, and move 51 yards for the touchdown. Great speed by Davis, and great run.
Those are the game breakers. You hold him down for such a long time, and then all of a sudden explodes for 51. You had 19 yards rushing before that. He has 70 now, and we have a tie game. After the Bulldogs jumped in front 14, it's now tied at 14.
We have a lot of happy Bronco fans who've traveled out here from Kalamazoo, Michigan, band and all, to watch their Western Michigan football team play. Let's see it one more time now. Rob Davis. He's only 5'8", 170 pounds, but look at him get through the hole. Boom, he explodes and he's gone. At that point, nobody's going to catch him. Safety can nowhere catch him at that point. Great track man as well for Western Michigan, Rob Davis.
And you're watching the longest touchdown run in Cowboy history. It breaks the 45-yard run by Rob Actor of Toledo back in 1981.
And that run makes the quarterback, Tony Kimbrough, very happy. Takes a lot of pressure off of him.
He's saying, I told you we could come back.
That's right.
And they have.
He says, I know we haven't been having a lot of success throwing the ball here, but let's just hang in there, and we will. In the meantime, Rob, keep running the ball like you're running.
And we still have 6 minutes and 45 seconds to play. Robinson. Oh, what a hit. Greg Powell. Well, there's a flag on the play, and Kelly Skipper is limping off the field. All of a sudden, Western Michigan has just grabbed that momentum.
And again, a well-coached football team like Western Michigan is not going to get flustered by their inability to move the ball early. They hung in there, stayed with it.
Well, here's the turning point in the ball game, and it came on that 3rd and 20. The deep pass to Alan Boyko, and J.D. Williams is caught for the pass interference.
Play official right here, friends. Is there interference? Did you see J.D. push Boyko? Well, the official sure did, and that turned the tone of the game.
And now Western Michigan's defense is paying off. Short run by Fresno State. We have 6.5 minutes left in this first half. Tied at 14. Andre Alexander, big touchdown catches of 55 and 38. And Robert Oliver from 32. He caught a touchdown pass from Tony Kimbrough, and Rob Davis just went 51 yards to tie things up. Pickens to the right, Alexander left. Second down, about 7. Catch is made by Alexander. Has the first down and knocked down near the 24-yard line. Willie Berrios, the tackle.
We haven't heard much from Willie Berrios today. He's one of the other unheralded players on that Western Michigan team, but Andre Alexander has sure made his name a household word here this afternoon and all across the country. Folks who haven't had a chance to see Fresno State play, Andre Alexander is a game breaker.
Well, he's now gone over 100 yards receiving on the game. They give it to the fullback, and he is hogtied off the left side, Myron Jones, and he's slow in getting up. There's Jim Sweeney with that smile on his face.
Yeah, he won't be smiling at halftime.
At the luncheon yesterday, you know, he was honored as the coach of the year in the Big West Conference this year, and he said, I've had a lot of losing in my career, so I'm plenty humble. I know what it's like to be behind.
These guys right here have had a lot of losing in their careers at Western Michigan, but not this year.
Al Mobley doing a remarkable job with the program. Again, Jones straight in the middle. Near a first down, they'll still need about a yard. It'll be third and one.
And again, where does Fresno State go when they want to run the ball? They go right behind Paul Vial, their junior out of Fresno. He didn't have to go very far to play major college football. Injured much of last year, Vial, number 73, opening the holes on that left side for the running game of Fresno State.
Number 63 calling the signals is Eric Hoffman. He's the second all-time leading tackler in Western Michigan history. The leader, of course, is the all-pro John Offerdahl, the Miami Dolphins. Double tight end, wishbone offense. Barsoni on the option, keeps it himself on the bootleg.
And it finally works for Jim Sweeney.
Oh, gosh. And, you know, the assistant coaches never want to call it play. Jim loves to call it because everybody knows where the ball is going to go, straight up the field.
Take a look at Eric Hoffman. He thinks it's coming right up the middle. He dives over the top. He's tackled three guys in the backfield. Problem is, none of them have the football. Barsoni, nice. Look, did you see the defender ran right by him? Literally ran right by him, and Barsoni picks up the first down. That's a good call.
And if Paul Davis doesn't make the right read and get out there to tackle Barsoni, Mark is gone for the long touchdown. And Barsoni calls time, but there's a flag thrown before that, so it'll be first and 15.
Just not enough time to change the signals at the line of scrimmage. We're seeing a lot of that today, and I think part of it is because it's a bowl game, because these two teams don't see each other. They've got all kinds of audibles put in this football game for the different defensive and offensive strategies that they're not used to seeing.
Jim Sweeney is proud of the Big West players he's put together this year. And he has a couple that he will send out wide right, Pickens and Alexander. It's first and 15, and the run goes up the middle near the 35-yard line. Short gain, maybe 2 yards. It will be second down and 13.
Andre Cook's on the draw play. And once again, Fresno State saying they want to own the draw, because anytime you can take your quarterback out from under center, drop him back, looking like he's going to pass and then slip the ball off, you're taking advantage of that defense who's thinking pass all the way. That time, Western Michigan doing a good job playing the run.
Anthony Williams leaves the game. Pickens is in. Barsoni sets. Completes the pass, and no, Pickens could not hold on to the sideline. He laid it in there nicely.
And then he was laid out after he threw the ball. And Steve, we talk about quarterback sacks. You may only get one or two sacks on a quarterback all day long, but if you can continue to knock him down after he throws the ball, that really takes its toll. By the fourth quarter, you're looking at one tired, beat-up quarterback.
Third down and 13. Barsoni in trouble, wants to go deep again. And the ball is dropped to the 25-yard line. You know, on the deep passes, it almost looked like the receiver was letting the ball come to him, Darryl Rosette. You still have to go get it with your hands.
Rosette had the ball in his hands. Now watch, he gets behind the secondary. The ball's going to be a little bit underthrown, but he just keeps his eye, look around, see what's going on, find your position. Now reach out and grab that ball. Oh, you let it bounce up against your chest and just slide right out. Darryl, you can't do that, son.
So it's over par lighter time. Ooh, he almost had that punt blocked. Ageman lets it go. 32 yards on the punt. After a great beginning, Overpar Leiter has hit some short ones. And with 2.5 minutes to play in this first half, it's a 14-14 ball game. For the Big West, honorees for Fresno State. Look at them. They got a ton of them. Truchel, Skidmore on the offensive line. Jones, the tight end. Skipper on the running back. And almost the entire defense. McCutcheon, Cox, Rogers, Williams, and Harris. Those are all first-team members of the Big West this year. And there were plenty that they thought should have been honored that were not. Like Brian Greer, who made the second team, and Nick Ruggieroli, who just made honorable mention. 32-yard line. He rolled time. Dumps it off. Has his man. Good game. Near first down is Ageman.
That's an excellent call by Western Michigan. Getting Ageman, swinging him out of the backfield, and forcing a linebacker to try to get outside and cover him. And there's no way a linebacker is going to cover Paul Ageman.
Gain of 8, so they'll need 2 on second down. With the blitz from the outside, but it's well picked up. And this is Alan Boyko. He's knocked out of bounds at the 5-yard line. Kimbrough suddenly has the time, and what a difference that makes.
A great fake by Kimbrough in the backfield as he looks off to the right side, and J.D. Williams on the near sideline bit. Number 31, the defensive back, got hung up, and look at Boyko. Just run right by him. The twin brothers from Hamilton, Ontario. Look at this pass. I mean, about a 35, 40-yard pass right on the line, and then Boyko does the rest, taking it down to the 5-yard line.
55 yards in the play. Western Michigan fans on their feet and applauding their Broncos, who have come back from a 14-0 deficit. And here they have a first and goal and a chance to take the lead. Rob Davis is stopped at the 3. Brian Greer, Garnett Fountain, both there.
Along with number 99, Joe Gigantino, he was also in on the play. But again, the draw play that time working to Rob Davis inside, picked up a couple.
Fresno State wants timeout. And they get it with 1 minute and 21 seconds in the clock here in the first half. 14-14 ball game. Kimbrough comes to the sideline. He has brought his team back after they were down 14-0. He threw a touchdown pass to Robert Oliver. He gave the football to Rob Davis, who went 51 yards. And now he has just thrown 55 yards to Alan Boyko. And all of a sudden, their offensive line and backs are picking up the blitzing Bulldogs.
And they're trying to get rid of that ball in a hurry. And that's exactly why they're neutralizing that quick pass rusher, Fresno State. The look off to the right side is what made that play for Kimbrough, because J.D. Williams, number 31, was fooled. He literally froze in his tracks and allowed Boyko to just run behind him. And then with a perfectly thrown pass, you just can't stop it.
Kimbrough struggled early. Now he has 211 yards passing, and we've got some great college basketball action coming your way on ESPN tonight. LSU and Florida. That should be a good one at 7:30. Dwayne Shinsius and company, 7:30 Eastern time. And Seton Hall, ranked number 20. Big East. Is this the opener? Yes, St. John.
And it's not much. They've just made some great plays, a couple of big plays.
17-14. Fresno State jumped on top 14-0. Western Michigan has roared back in this game. And here's a look at that play by Tony Kimbrough.
One more time, look to the end zone for Bruce Boyko, number 30, and watch him stretch and almost come down with this pass. This kind of game is a receiver's dream, I'll tell you. The way these quarterbacks like to throw, and both these offenses enjoy putting the ball up. Oh, I wish I was 15 years younger. I'd still be too old, but I wish I were 15 years younger.
And then still be running the wishbone at Georgia Tech.
That's exactly right.
Steve Rabel played at Georgia Tech, then went on to the Seattle Seahawks, where he made Steve Largent a superstar. On the return, this is Jeff Thiessen. Out across the 30-yard line. Still 32 seconds left in the first half. And knowing Jim Sweeney. He'll put it in the air. You know, this game's on ESPN, and both coaches, Al Mohle and Jim Sweeney, were excited about that because they get to show the rest of the country and all those recruits out there the type of exciting football that they run. And if I'm a recruit, I'd say, hey, that's the kind of program I want to play for.
You bet, especially if I'm a quarterback or a receiver and now a running back at Fresno State or an offensive lineman. If you like to run block, this is the place. As well. Winning programs draw the great athletes, and both these schools have winning programs.
Barsotti goes up top, but there's a deep zone, and the pass is intercepted. Andre Alexander goes back to play defensive back, and Paul Davis, he is in his second interception of the game. Yes, it is. He has five on the year, and this young man is just a freshman.
You know, Steve, that's the first deep pass that Barsotti has thrown today that is not the typical Bulldog bomb. He laid this one out on a line, which is not what the Fresno State coaches teach. Look, he overthrew his receiver by 4 or 5 yards. Paul Davis is the only guy out there who can make the catch. The key to the Bulldog deep pass is to at least give your receiver an opportunity to fight for that football. Alexander didn't have a chance.
So it's a long punt, actually. 22 seconds left. Western Michigan says, hey, we like what we have right now, and that's a three-point lead. We're going to take that to halftime. Both teams have already split for halftime. As the clock winds down inside of 10 seconds, the brown and gold have come back, and come back well. With halftime here, Jim Sweeney leaves the football. The second half is underway. Steve Loop with the kickoff. Boyko with the return, and he is really tied down at the 28-yard line. Craig Jones on the tackle. And we were talking about the possession, Steve Rabel. 24 possessions, 12 by Fresno State, 12 by Western Michigan. These are the last five by the Broncos.
We're keeping our graphics people hopping downstairs trying to keep up with all this. But as you can see, finally, once Western Michigan got on track and Kimbrough got hot, he was able to find the touchdown pass to Oliver, and that opened up the running attack and allowed Rod Davis to go 52 for the touchdown.
Now, how many times have you heard of coaches say that those first moments of the second half are so important to make sure you either have the momentum or get it back? So Tony Kimbrough wants to do that here. He hands off to Rob Davis in the first play, and it's a loss of maybe 2 yards. Fourth down, we'll call it 11 instead.
Willie Howard in on the tackle for Fresno State. I think that's where a lot of the talk came at halftime for this Fresno State team, is on defense. Say, guys, we have been winning on defense this year. We have got to stop this Western Michigan ball club.
Well, after a long first half, the shadows creeping over Bulldog Stadium. We're late into the afternoon. Kimbrough on the option himself, keeps it, and he's in the defensive backfield, and he's finally cut down across the 45-yard line. Well, he's an excitable young man, raising that fist to the air, and you don't think he has the respect of his entire offense?
This is a called quarterback draw. Look at that. Three steps back, and then Kimbrough takes off. Now, that's strength right there to pull away from that tackle. But here is the speed as he runs away from everyone, and only a shoestring tackle by Marquez Pope saves 6 points for Fresno State.
First and 10, momentum Broncos way. Timing pattern, but Boyko cannot hold on. He had it in his left hand. Coverage came from J.D. Williams.
You know, when you throw as much as Kimbrough does, you have to expect once in a while you're going to have a drop. But on the other side of the coin, that really can hurt the confidence of the entire offense. Your line is up there working hard. That ball's catchable. You got to stick both hands out there and make that catch, Allen.
He's thrown 36 passes now, and we're in the opening minute of the first half. 214 yards. And they held them under 90 yards until the final 8 minutes of the first half. Rolling away from the pressure, rolling away from Jeff White, and finally out of bounds at the 38-yard line. You know, when we talked to Cliff Hysel, he thought the three things that would be very, very good for this football team were running the draw and also rolling out with the pass away from that defensive pressure.
And that's exactly what Kimbrough did. In fact, we're seeing Kimbrough literally take control of this ball game by himself. If you're going to have everybody from Fresno State rushing that quarterback, then give the quarterback an opportunity to make a couple of big plays on his own, which he has done.
37-yard line. They'll bring a tight end in now. Go with one slot to the left side. Coakley is the tight end. Davis will get the carry. Davis near a first down. He needs to get to the 33 for the first down. He's knocked down at the 35-yard line. So it'll be a third down, short. You know, let me ask you this, Steve. You're working with a young quarterback, Barsotti, who's 19 years old. Kimbrough will be 25 in January. He's been a Marine, a radio operator in the Marine. He's been all over the country. He's been in junior college and a college in North Carolina. How much of that is a factor as far as poison coming back?
I think certainly the maturity factor that Tony Kimbrough has is something that Barsotti has yet to learn, and that maturity is spreading through this Western Michigan football team.
Big third down. Davis will not get it. Willie Howard making the stop. Tracy Rogers also there.
Chuck McCutcheon in on the play as well. This is just team speed for Fresno State, getting off of blocks and getting to the point of attack. And Davis on a third down play, you've got to bust this play up inside. You can't stand back in that backfield and look for something to open up in a third and short. That's when you have to take it upfield and make that short yardage on your own.
So Fresno State takes over. Barsotti remains in there. Dave Telford is on the sideline, and he is an experienced senior quarterback who threw for over 2,000 yards last year. They have gone to him in the past, but they will stick with Barsotti here. Rosette, 50-yard line. He has great speed. Darryl Rosette for the touchdown. 65 yards.
And what a way to break open the second half offensively for Fresno State. This, they've done it all year long. Run the ball, and Darryl Rosette, who is taking over here for a banged-up Clyde Skipper in the second half. One move, two moves, breaks through the line. A good block downfield by his wide receiver, Andre Alexander. And Rosette, with his 4-4 speed, is off to the races.
Boy, have we had a game of big plays. 55 yards, 51 yards, 38 yards.
We've just broken the record for touchdown runs. For a 65-yarder.
And we have a dandy in Fresno, California. The Bulldogs now lead by 4.
We're not a company, but we recognize potential. We develop it. We use it. We'll make sure that as your responsibility grows, so will you. As your ability for leadership grows, so will you. Working with us, you'll gain self-confidence, become a person with a future. We're not a company. We're your country. We're the Marines, the Army, the Navy, the Air Force. We're the Armed Forces. It's a great place to start.
You wouldn't believe the stuff my dad had to do to get his hands on his dream machine. You name it, he'd do it. Here's my dream machine, the new Cutlass Supreme. And all I had to do to get one was go to my old dealer.
This is not your father's Oldsmobile. This is the new generation.
Wow! Buy a new 89 Cutlass Supreme by December 31st and get $500 cash back.
Looks like winter just did in that poor fellow's battery. Wonder if he knows the real killer was the heat last summer. Wonder if he's smart enough to replace it with a battery built for extremes. Smart enough to get the maintenance-free, high-cranking Delco.
Precision AC Delco parts. They don't just fit, they match.
Smart fella, could be a Jaeger. For the AC Delco retailer nearest you, just give me a call at 1-800-AC-DELCO.
Fresno State now leads 21-17 over Western Michigan, and the 1988 California Bowl is brought to you by the new generation of Oldsmobile. Step into the future now at your Oldsmobile dealer. And by the U.S. Armed Forces, it's a great place to start. Here's the kickoff. Bulldogs up by 4, and another nice return by Ajima. Well, Darryl Rosette just went 65 yards to put the Bulldogs in the lead. He got great blocking up front, and then it was speed.
Good move at the line of scrimmage as he breaks through, gets a couple of blocks downfield, including his wide receiver, Andre Alexander. As we look at it from on high, watch the speed. He'll run away from the secondary. Ooh, I love receivers that block downfield. Nice play by Darryl Rosette.
From the 28. Kimbrough amid a great pressure, but Craig Bowens can't hold on.
That has interception written all over it, and nobody is more frustrated than Craig Bowens. Kimbrough expecting his receiver to break to the middle of the field. Instead, he broke wide toward the flag. Kimbrough let her rip, and Craig Bowens almost had himself his fifth interception on the year.
It's like going up a hill and down a hill. The momentum just riding back and forth. Kimbrough leaves the running backs alone. Here's the blitz. Loops the pass downfield, but well over his target, but another flag. Alan Boyko, the intended receiver.
Fresno State players kind of walking back, looking at each other. And now it is going to go against the Bulldogs.
That's the second time they've been called for defensive holding in the game. Jim Sweeney. Well, you can see the way he's gritting his teeth. He's not pleased. Defense does the job, and they get the holding, and it's automatic first down.
Just one of the many things that these teams have to overcome, this kind of loss of momentum, the
players on the sidelines for Fresno State starting to wave those towels, trying to get their hometown fans into this football game.
Ajima, the lone setback. And he gets it. Forget it. Ron Cox. Sporting News said he was the best redshirt freshman in the nation last year.
Sporting News knows whereof they speak. Cox was blocked by a couple of guys that time. He wasn't going to have any part of it.
You know, he's a great story. He lives with his grandmother, and he told her many years ago, I guess he was like 14 years old, she asked him, what can you do to be a better football player? And he said, well, Grandma, I think I need weights. She went out and laid out $5,000 to buy him a complete weight set. And he built himself up into a 230-pound all-Big West linebacker.
Offenses are paying for it to this day.
Second down, 14. Cox again. He drives over the tackle, but Kimbrough escapes. First down. He'll be about 2 yards shy. It'll be third down and two after an 11-yard run by Kimbrough, and now a flag flies.
A late flag comes in from Jack Baker, the referee, and I think he's going to say Kimbrough was hit out of bounds and late, and we may tack some more onto this one. Oh, that was a late flag. You know, you mentioned it earlier in the game, Steve. We have a split crew here today, some from Pac-10, some from the WAC, and it's going to go against Fresno State.
Well, Fresno State was the most penalized team in the Big West Conference this year, along with San Jose State. And you don't want to take away from their ferocious ability, but you certainly don't want to see those yellow flags.
That's right, and you don't want to see your quarterback hurt out of bounds either. That's the reason those rules are in there, to try to protect that guy as he's going to the ground and out of bounds.
Now you've got to protect that quarterback, not by simply the offenses, but by the referees. We've seen the NFL damaged this year. Too many quarterbacks out for the year. Kimbrough has time. There's Ajima. He'll have the first down and a bundle more. Rogers finally knocks down Ajima, but not before he has a 19-yard gain.
How many times in the first half did we see Kimbrough unable to complete that pass because he threw it too hard, threw it too much toward the sidelines? Look at the back swinging out of the backfield. Everybody runs off with their man. Well, here comes Tracy Rogers. That's his man, Ajima, and he's got to come from all the way on the other side of the field. There's no way he can get there. So Western Michigan has gone in at halftime and decided, here is how we take advantage of the Bulldog defense.
Rob Davis is now in the backfield. Boyko is in the slot on the right side with Ajima. Kimbrough to Davis. Not much there, just a 2 yard gain. And you know, we just saw that screen pass for a great deal of success. The defensive coaches at Fresno State said they have to stop the draw, the screen, the rollout pass. The rollout pass has burnt them today, and so too has the screen pass.
You know, Stephen, we talked about game plans. You can have the greatest game plan in the world, but your players eventually have to go out there and make that play. I mean, it's one thing to say you have to stop the screen, and it's something else to get somebody out there to make the play.
There's a rollout pass, and it's complete. Boyko again. 15-yard line. Boyko twins. Hamilton, Ontario. Nobody knew about them, and they sent letters to all over the country, including Fresno State, because no one would recruit them because Canadian high school football is not that respected. But they prove they can play.
They're both very tough, very dependable receivers, and they hang on to just about everything that gets near them. They've meant a lot to this Western Michigan club.
So is this guy. He has been fun to watch today. Kimber with time, Davis with the catch, and the touchdown. 15 yards, and Western Michigan retakes the lead.
Jeff White, the defensive back for Fresno State, gets fooled on this one, and Davis is going to make that catch out in the flat. So successful has this been here already in the second half for the Broncos. Jeff White, no way he can make the play on that.
Robert Oliver with a good block, but Davis with his first touchdown catch of the year. He scored 12 on the ground, but none by way of the air, and he finally does here, and Creek adds a point after, and it's 24-21, Broncos over the Bulldogs.
We remember Western Michigan was so close in the first half to hitting these plays. Kimbrough just couldn't bring the ball down and get it to his receivers. This time he fires it right on the numbers to Davis, and now it's just a matter of outrunning Jeff White to the end zone, and there's no contest there.
Well, you're seeing a good college football game today. Tomorrow you'll see a great football game with Seattle going against Denver. But first at 11:30, Chris Berman. And everybody has all the previews and features at 11:30 Eastern Time. Then NFL Primetime, the scores and highlights, 7 o'clock Eastern Time, that game with the pregame on Primetime, and then the game at 8 o'clock, Seattle and Denver. Who's going to win that contest?
Well, I've got to say the Seahawks, two teams that are 7-7 and fighting for a playoff berth in the AFC West, looking to win the AFC Western Championship. The Broncos, they're tough when they come up to Seattle to play in that kingdom.
Different story in the kingdom, isn't it, from when they leave and go to other places?
Well, it sure is, and that home field advantage really helps the Seahawks. This home field advantage here today has not been as great as the Bulldogs would like. Their fans have really not been making the kind of noise that Jim Sweeney and his team would love to hear on their sidelines.
See that look on that young man's face? We've got an onside kick, and Western Michigan, did it go far enough? I believe it did. And the Broncos have recovered.
Try everything and try it at least once. And Al Moldy pulling an onside kick out. We're going to see if the ball traveled 10 yards before it was touched. Here comes the kicker with the onside. There it's gone 5 yards. Will it get 10? It looks sure like it was made 10 yards before it was touched.
And it's the kicker, Creek, who made the recovery. This guy's a soccer player. He's dribbling the ball.
That's just being aware up front. As a coaching staff, you have to tell your kickoff return team, always be aware. Don't turn your heads and run away till that ball is kicked. Once again, Al Moldy thinking about two moves ahead in this chess game called the California Bowl.
Well, right now, the king of Kalamazoo is Al Moldy. He has done a remarkable job. Fresno State was picked to win by as many as 11 points. But Western Michigan right now is up by 3. And flag goes down. I believe there may have been movement in the offensive backfield. Rob Davis kind of fell forward and tried to stop himself.
That whole play was a mess from the start. And here's Al Moldy saying, sure, I know it was a penalty. This guy, that's a gutsy call, quite frankly. An onside kick at this point in the game, 10 minutes, 15 seconds left in the third quarter. He really is confident in what he's doing out there. You just talk to him, and he believes in what he does. And if he does make a bad call, he's the kind of coach, I think, that just puts it out of his mind and says, all right, we have a lot of time left. We're going to make something else good happen for ourselves. But don't sit back and wait for it to happen to you. Go out and win the game. Don't try not to lose.
Well, he's been very aggressive in this game. Now for the 42, first and 15. Inside rush. Kimbrough again rolls away from it. Incomplete. There's a flag. Pass interference. Well, Fresno State right now taking themselves out of the game. Every time they make a good defensive play, they make a pass interference. That's the third pass interference in this half alone.
We're getting man-to-man coverage across the board by Fresno State. They feel strongly about this. They feel like they have the athletes. Look, up and down the line, you can see a white jersey running with a dark jersey everywhere on the field. That's man-to-man coverage. And here comes the Western Michigan receiver to the near side. The ball is out in front of him. Really, there's not much way he's going to catch this, but the legs get tangled up, and Darryl Martin is called for the interference call on the Western Michigan receiver. And so once again, the Broncos in good field position with a first down.
You know, I said Fresno State has been the most penalized team in the Big West Conference this year. Well, that's certainly the case again. They have been hurt with 11 penalties in this game. It's first down, 10 yards to go. Kimbrough loops the pass beautifully. Boyko, no, this is Oliver. 15-yard line. 6 yards and the first down.
Holy smoke. I tell you, you play man-to-man defense, the roll goes to the far side and then throw back. A little corner route, and Oliver gets inside and then back outside. And do you think that Western Michigan maybe scouted and saw that Daryl Martin was not the best man-to-man cover guy, because he is really getting eaten up out here today by the Western Michigan wide receivers. And again, Kimbrough spreading out the glory, giving everybody a chance to make the big catches.
David Bell replaces Oliver now in the lineup after he hurt his right elbow after the catch. Kimbrough again with time. Incomplete. They will not call a pass interference after the receiver, Ajima, fell down.
Ajima tried to do too much out there. At first, he glanced back over his shoulder as though it were a little flare pass. Then he tried to turn upfield. Kimbrough threw the ball behind him. He tried to reach back and catch it. Kimbrough given a lot of time. Amazing that the Fresno State defense has been unable to get to Kimbrough here in the first half. He's had a lot of time to throw.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Kimbrough with 279 yards on the air. Inside of 10 minutes left in the third quarter. 3-point lead for the Broncos. Three, now four receivers on the left side. And a flag goes down.
And we'll get too much time once again on Western Michigan. They've got to get that play signaled in from the sidelines, and Tony Kimbrough has to get his offensive unit up to that line of scrimmage quicker.
There's the penalties. That's why we've had a long ball game, but an exciting one. 24-21. Fresno State is down by three.
And do you think those penalties have had anything to do with it? You bet they have. Big turning point, a pass interference call in the first half on Fresno State that gave Western Michigan an opportunity to get on the scoreboard early.
Kimbrough can't hear. He steps away, and this is exactly what his coach Al Mohle told him to do. He said the fans will start cheering, and not only cheering, but barking on the sideline like bulldogs.
And I think the official told Tony Kimbrough, you get up there and call the signals, because I'm not going to let you step away, and he forced Kimbrough to use a timeout. And that's what Al Mohle is really incensed about.
Said, don't let Jim Sweeney get that red towel and wave it over his head. 2 years ago, they were playing San Jose State. Fabulous football game here on ESPN. And Sweeney waved the towel over his head, and the team came back. The fans got into the football game. And Jim Sweeney was a big reason why. And Mohle heard all about that. He said, if that happens, you back away.
You look around Bulldog Stadium here, and you don't have any trouble seeing lots and lots of red for the Fresno State Bulldogs, including the head coach dressed in it. Al Mohle's trying to deal with it, and he told his quarterback, if you can't hear, you step away. Well, Jack Baker, the referee, just said, I'm not buying that, coach. And Tony Kimbrough, you guys find a way to make your signals heard or use silent signals, because we're going to get this game played.
Well, this will really get the crowd involved. And they will warn them soon. And then start to take timeouts away and then penalize them.
Now, quite frankly, I think the way you do this is, as the quarterback of the team in a hostile setting, you got to come up and use hand signals to your offense, use silent signals to get the play off. That's what quiets the crowd.
And the crowd doing their job, and Fresno State recovers the fumble. Well, that's the 12th man doing the job there. Kimbrough could not hear, and the offensive center, Doug Miller, couldn't hear, and he snapped the football too soon.
Tony, you got to tell the rest of your team what you're going to do, though, when you get up there, if you're going to go on that quick count. Kimbrough was not alert, not ready for the snap of the ball. Everybody else is moving, and Terry Cook falls on that ball. So, again, Tony Kimbrough, as mature as he is, lets this crowd get to it.
And several players in the Fresno State sideline turned around and pointed to the crowd like, you did it, you did it. You got us back in this football game. It's 24-21, 9:45 left in this third quarter. Now, you talk about comebacks in the California Bowl. Fresno State was once down 28-0 in 1982. They came back and won that football game 29-28. so they know all about poise and coming back. Barsotti, after the 6-yard gain by Fresno State, faces a 2nd and 4. First down, Darrell Rosette. I'm not sure what happened to Kelly Skipper, their senior, but it's been Rosette the entire second half. We remember seeing him limp off after the kickoff. He has not been in there since.
Right, and that could be, for a lot of teams, a very damaging thing. When your best running back, best all-around running back, may not have led the team in yardage gain, but he catches the ball well, he's a good blocker, and he's just such a coachable kid. When he's out of the game, that can hurt you. But Rosette's picked up the slack.
Barsotti in trouble now. He is a man open. Ooh, the Cooks with the pass behind, and there is a much frustrated fan.
Barsotti that time looking to go to the double screen. Watch him. He'll turn to his left here and fake the screen. Now he's looking back to the right, but a lot of pressure coming from Paul DeVries, the outside linebacker, now being chased, and he throws it behind his intended receiver, Adrian Cooks.
Do you have to try and loop that pass?
Well, you should, but when you're running away and falling away from your receiver, there's no looping about it. You just want to try to throw the ball and get it to him.
The Broncos defense have forced Barsotti into 5 straight incompletions. It's 2nd and 10. Little dump off. Myron Jones, plenty of room. There he goes, 50-yard line, first down. 19 yards for Myron Jones.
And Western Michigan had everybody but their coach coming on the blitz. Look at the two inside backers. Here they come. Good play by the quarterback in recognizing it. And Myron Jones just sneaking out to the side. Oh, did he take a shot from Willie Berrios, who's going to make him pay for the big pickup and the first down for Fresno State.
Well, even the defensive coaches said Berrios doesn't have great speed, but man, will he stick you. First and 10, 48-yard line. Rosette. Gain for the 46. Eric Hoffman there again. He had 179 tackles this year, 22 against Wisconsin. Rosette's had a good game.
Think about that. Eric Hoffman, the leading tackler on this ball club for Western Michigan, in games has gone well over 20 tackles a game at times. That is a figure that I just cannot comprehend, more than 20 tackles in a game.
And you just go home and sit in the jacuzzi after that.
For about 4 days.
2nd and 8. And we got another one. Well, we're getting familiar with that.
Yeah, in the record books, this one's going to go down as the Hanky Bowl, in parentheses, behind California Bowl.
The Hanky track meet. Mm-hmm. We've seen the Hankies. We've also seen a lot of yardage.
Illegal procedure is the call.
Darrell Rosette continues at that running back spot. Skipper, we understand, is physically able to play, just not getting back into the ball game right now. And after that long run by Rosette just a little earlier, possibly understandable why.
2nd and 13. Barsotti, though, 0 for his last 5. He completes this one, though, and Myron Jones has the first down. Just barely. He needed 13, he got 14, and Berrios again with the big stick.
Myron Jones is just a dangerous out of the backfield because as the fullback, he has 4.33 speed, legitimate, world-class speed. The little rollout buys Barsotti some time, and now there's no way that Smangy or any of the inside linebackers can hope to keep up with Jones out of the backfield. Their only hope is to run him close to the sidelines and then knock him into the bench.
Fresno State down by 3. They're moving inside Steve Loop territory. He's the field goal kicker. Alexander in motion left-right. Good inside move by Rosette. Berrios again with the tackle.
One of the big guys up front helping Rosette along, Jeff Skidmore, the big junior out of Bakersfield, California. A lot of injuries in his career, but nice block that time to spring Rosette for about 5.
Darrell Rosette started his collegiate career at Arizona State. Then he went to to a junior college where he was kind of a halfback wide receiver situation. Caught his receiving yardage was higher than his rushing totals. And here he's found a nice home at Fresno State. They have another yellow flag. 13 penalties for 100 yards for Fresno State.
Procedure call against Fresno State. You'd think Fresno State had taken like 3 weeks off or something from football. The way their the penalties are coming and kind of inconsistent play on their part. No, they've been at it ever since the final game of the season and practicing a normal schedule right here at home.
145 total yards and penalties by these two clubs. Adrian Cooks, nope. Not a whole lot there. Third down and long. 9 yards to go. They stuffed it with Johnson and Prowse and Mulhern.
You know who we haven't talked about since the early stages of this ball game is Joel Smenge.
You know, I would imagine I would run away from him as often as possible.
But even with his speed, he can make those plays from the backside. Somebody's doing a good job blocking number 89 in the dark jersey.
Pressure there. Barsoni, great catch by Myron Jones, 20-yard line. Jones to the 5, and down he goes. What a pass by Barsoni, falling down. 30 yards.
You are so right. This is just a great athletic play by Barsoni to get rid of this pass. He's chased out of the pocket. The blitz by the inside backers. He sees it coming. He flips the ball away, takes a shot as he passes it, and Myron Jones does the rest using that speed. Look at Andre Alexander downfield blocking. You don't see many wide receivers who will throw their bodies around like that to block.
First and goal from the 4. Rosette. Touchdown! Second string running back. He has 8 touchdowns this year.
And he's got the Fresno fans jumping. Rosette finds a little hole inside and just barrels right through the Western Michigan defense.
Look at the blocking by Radiman and Paul Deal.
Just right up the gut. That's just straight football right there. As a Western Michigan player remains on the turf.
Back and forth we go. Fresno State has now claimed the lead by 3. They can make it 4. That's Paul Johnson, their outstanding defensive lineman. John Manier plays very well, so he'll come on to replace him. Let's just hope that Paul Johnson is all right. He's only a freshman. They have he's going to have one great future.
You know, from 1987, that guy was a running back and a tight end until they moved him over to a down defensive line position. He's slow to get up, but he is getting up now.
Moldy's in the sideline clapping his hands as Johnson gets up. He's trying to fire up his team again.
You know what we have here, Steve? We've got a track meet, as you mentioned a little earlier, that whoever has this ball last is going to win this game. The way it appears, the way these two teams now have found their offensive prowess, moving the ball up and down the field.
Paul Johnson from Rockford, Illinois. I called him a freshman. He's a sophomore. Excuse me. I don't know why I put it in my flip chart that he's only a freshman. He's still got a great future.
He's got a lot of years ahead of him as a Bronco.
Holly will hold. Luke will try and give Fresno State a 4-point lead. And he does. And it's 28-24. Bulldogs over the Broncos. We've got a good one here in Fresno, California.
Down. Come home a little late, they put their foot down. My mom's no different. I get this great new Oldsmobile Cutlass Cali with a quad 4-engine. And what does she do? You got it.
This is not your father's Oldsmobile.
I put my foot down. Uh-oh.
This is new generation of
the difference between the AC Delco parts that go into race cars and the ones that go into your car? There isn't any.
Precision AC Delco parts. They don't just fit, they match.
If you want to win, run with a winner. For the AC Delco retailer nearest you, just give me a call at 1-800-AC-DELCO.
Your man in Washington has come through.
The Americans will be most displeased. Observe. The argon-activated radio-optic laser light.
Amusing, Boris, but the party demanded Bud Light.
If you want the one light that outshines them all, ask for Bud Light.
Where is Boris? He is enjoying a cold one.
Bud Light, because everything else is just a light.
There's the injured Western Michigan Bronco, Paul Johnson, their defensive lineman. He appears to be all right, but we'll wait word on that. Meantime, Fresno State claiming a four-point edge with 5.5 minutes left in the third quarter. Rosette with the final 4 yards for the touchdown now has 94 yards in this game. And a nice tackle by Marquez Pope at the 19-yard line, and another flag goes down. And here's the touchdown by Rosette. 9 carries, 94 yards, 2 touchdowns in the game.
And look at him just sneak through there, and all of a sudden he explodes into the end zone. The penalty, though, an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty, we'll get to that. 11-play drive and 80 yards, that has got to make Jim Sweeney a happy man on the far sideline. This gets back to Fresno State football of 1988, mixing in the run and the pass, but scoring again on the run. Now take a look at the penalty here on the kickoff. Marquez Pope is going to make the tackle, but Marquez, you got to leave well enough alone, buddy. You've got him on the ground. Don't stand up and do that. The officials are going to throw a flag. That's taunting.
Oh. Well, he's a freshman. He'll learn.
He will.
Because you know the coach on the sideline will sit him down for a little while. Kimbrough can't hear. This hurt them before. The last time Kimbrough came away and then went back to the line of scrimmage and the Red Wave fans were howling. The center could not hear. The signal snapped the football too early. A fumble on the play. Fresno went down and scored the touchdown.
And I'll tell you exactly what Jack Baker is saying. We had one of these problems in Green Bay years ago playing against the Packers. Dave Craig came out of the huddle, brought us to the line, and we could not hear anything. Wide receivers, slot backs, tight ends, no one. Jack Patera told him step away from the center, and he did, and we stood there. We stood on that field for 10 minutes while the fans screamed. The officials kept telling us to go to the line of scrimmage, but you don't call a penalty in the pros on
that. So Dave Craig did not give him the George Bush line of read my lips?
Hardly. And then, as it turned out, we ended up 3 downs and out. Green Bay went back and scored and won the ball game on us. So the crowd did have an effect. But you have got to go up as a quarterback and make something happen, because this crowd will only get louder. They're not going to quiet down for you.
And let's listen to them. Now the Bulldog defense is saying, settle down. We're going to have a timeout taken away. Fresno State has 3 timeouts left. Broncos have 2. To the Bulldogs. You got to train them well. It's down boy. Settle down.
Now a flag is thrown by the official on the far side of the field. Let's see what he's going to call. There is no flag because there is no 25-second clock. They're not going to wind that chain up.
Blitz on. Kimbrough steps up and escapes for maybe a 4-yard gain. No quarterback has been able to do this to Fresno State this year. I mean, has the escapability. The Big West has some fine quarterbacks. Jeff Graham of Long Beach State. Brent Snyder, who you saw on ESPN game earlier this year. They're straight drop-back quarterbacks. And Kimbrough has basically made his own opportunities happen.
He has. He's used that athletic ability to find himself areas outside the pocket for no other reason than the fact that there's not much of a pocket there for much of this ball game.
He gains 4. He needs 6. Rob Davis with a nice move. almost fumbles the football, and again, a flag goes.
Nick Ruggieroli trying to fire up the crowd, but we've got a penalty going against Western Michigan.
Well, we've got some basketball coming your way sometime tonight. LSU against Florida, and then Seton Hall against St. John's. And on the East Coast, we're nearing the tip-off of that LSU-Florida game. You think they're going to hold it up for us? I don't think so. But we will go to it. And Bob Carpenter, as soon as this game ends, we still have 5:24 left in the third quarter. Bob Carpenter and referee are probably sitting there. Wait a second.
Yeah, they ought to set up a big screen and watch the rest of this game. I mean, with an exciting offensive shootout we've got here right now.
Fumbled the ball twice in the game. He's thrown for two touchdowns. He's rushed for 35 yards. He's thrown for 279. And this is his final game as a Western Michigan Bronco. And he has put on a splendid display. Rogers almost got him. Kimbrough will run for the first down, or very close. He fumbles, and it's the Bulldogs football. His third fumble of the game.
That ball very nearly went out of bounds. Had it, Western Michigan keeps control. The officials are talking about it right now. But Kimbrough, wanting to get that first down, doesn't slide. Look at him, stay up. That's where the ball came out. He was hit right square in a bread basket. And the ball, as you can see, stays in bounds. Brian Greer is the one that falls on it for Fresno State.
But, Steve, it was the guy who was penalized earlier. Marquez Pope, look at him, stick his helmet right in Kimbrough's stomach where the football is.
In fact, the ball started to slide out even before Pope put his hat on it. Kimbrough not tucking that ball away, as he should have.
Now, the officials are talking at midfield. Could they be discussing? They've changed their minds three times in this ball game.
They may be discussing, A, whether Greer was in bounds enough to make that fumble recovery. Half of his body was out of the playing field. And they're going to give it to Fresno State. The recovery will go to Brian Greer. And we'll look one more time. Watch number 11. And the ball is coming out there. Pope hits him. The ball is out. Now it's on the ground. Brian Greer, 69. He grabs it in his arms, and his feet are out of bounds. That's what the officials were discussing. They say Fresno State has control, and they recover.
Great camera work, guys, right on top of it. Rosette, short gain. And it seems like, Steve, every time there's been a turnover, there has been a touchdown. So we'll see if Al Mohle can rally his troops, because it seems like anytime you have an emotional switch like that, for just a moment, you get down.
Opportunistic ball clubs, both of these groups. Opportunistic, looking for that opportunity to capitalize.
Well, on the other side, the Broncos cheerleaders look like they're winning their fight with the Bulldog mascot. Second seven. Rosette, quick opener. Into the defensive backfield and near a first down. He must get to the 36-yard line. Eric Hoffman, Paul DeVries making the tackle. Well, he's had a great game. He's over 100 yards rushing now. 106 and the two touchdowns. His best game this year. He's the only back to go over 100 yards. A 15 rush, 148-yard performance earlier this year.
We finally see Fresno State is caught up in its running the football. They now run more than they pass. That's what they wanted to do.
They need a yard. They needed just to get across the 36.
And there wasn't much there. Pretty tough going up the middle. It's going to be depending on which foot the official. There we go. He does spot it ahead, so that gives Fresno State the first down. Nice job by the big guys up front for Fresno State. We haven't talked about him a lot here in the second half, but Lujan and Vial, Radiman, Skidmore, Truchel, the offensive lineman for Jim Sweeney's Fresno State Bulldogs.
From the 35, Alexander left. Pickens to the right. Bar- Sarasota, quick pass. Pickens with the catch. About an 8-9 yard gain. Berrios there for the tackle with Henderson.
Pickens came here because he wanted that football thrown in his direction. This guy didn't play high school football. He's come on and done a fine job here at Fresno State.
Well, he was recruited by everybody, by Miami, UCLA, Arizona State. Fabulous wide receiver in junior college. He led El Camino to a 24-6 Pony Bowl victory over Taft, where he was the MVP of that game, catching six passes for 177 yards and three touchdowns. That was 1 year ago, almost to the day. Here's team faces second down. Oh, there's Hoffman.
Big time mismatch there as Myron Jones was trying to block on Eric Hoffman. Big number 63. Again, they list him at 233 pounds, but he doesn't look that big. Without his equipment on, he's got the big neck collar, the big shoulder pads, all the dirty, muddy elbow pads.
Third down and one. Myron Jones breaks into the backfield. He could go. Touchdown, Fresno State. Yards and the touchdown on a third and one.
Get in that wishbone, just looking for some power offense, and Jones makes this play by jumping over the tackle and running out of another tackle, and it's off to the races. Myron Jones too fast, nobody's going to catch him.
Loop on and point number 35 across for Fresno State. 35-24, Fresno State has a lead with 2:08 to play in the third.
AAA Transmissions is celebrating their grand opening with a great transmission service special. For just $19.95, AAA will install new transmission fluid and a new pan gasket. Adjust the bands and the linkage. Check the modulator and U-joints and check for leaks, all for just $19.95. AAA is the newest, most modern transmission repair facility in Fresno. AAA also offers free towing and backs its work with the best warranty around. So look for the sign of quality. AAA Transmissions on Blackstone near Griffith or call 225-6254.
Well, when you come into Long's Building Supply, you can expect to get taken care of. An experienced salesman is going to come up and ask if you need some help, and they're going to stay with you until you're done, until you no longer need any help. We give that good price, and we expand on that and give them the good service and the good quality. And in the long run, that's what counts.
My father drove a starship, so it's only natural I'd fly around in something space age. My new Oldsmobile Cutlass Supreme, totally redesigned for the future. It's powered by a fuel-injected V6, monitored by an onboard computer. I guess some things were just meant for the next generation. Ready, Dad?
I'm ready. You ready?
I'm ready.
Steady as she goes. This is the new generation.
Fresno State can't feel comfortable with an 11-point lead. They had a 14-point advantage in the first half, and Western Michigan came right back. Well, Steve Loop will kick off. He gave him the 35th point. Boyko will be on the return. 27-yard line. Basketball is coming your way on ESPN very soon. Bob Carpenter for the LSU-Florida game. And then we will have Seton Hall. We may be going to the Seton Hall-St. John's game first. That's at 9:30 Eastern time. This game started at 1 o'clock in the afternoon Pacific time, 4 o'clock Eastern time, so already 7:30. And we've got 2 minutes left in the third quarter. Kimbrough completes the pass out of bounds, 32-yard line. And, you know, we were talking about how turnovers have led to the touchdowns in this football game. And this is how it's looked.
21 points that Fresno State has picked up, including this run by Myron Jones. And again, stepping over one tackle, running out of the arms of another. Goodbye, Western Michigan.
Part of that new Eagle, Bear, Bulldog defense. So many men on that line of scrimmage. Here's the deep pass to Ajima. He reaches for it. It's incomplete. Steve, let me ask you about that. With so many men on the line of scrimmage, Myron Jones really only had to elude one tackle, and then he was gone. Is that part of the difficulty of the Bear defense that was brought on by Buddy Ryan of the Eagles?
Well, sure. You're depending on your athletes, and you figure they're good enough athletes. That's why you put them all up there on the line of scrimmage to make that play. You figure that somebody is going to slide out and make the tackle. Fresno State also figures, we're going to block this in such a way that they can't get somebody from inside out to make the play. Two guys had their shots at him. Two guys broke free. Neither one made the play, and Myron Jones goes for six.
Now Tony Kimbrough faces a third and five. Rogers and Cox came from the inside. Kimbrough again escapes for the first down. Oh, he is fun to watch. And they have been the matchup we talked about earlier, Kimbrough against Barsotti. Kimbrough, the three things that have cost him are the fumbles. Barsotti has been hurt by the interceptions, but only one of them have resulted in a touchdown.
I think one thing we don't show in this comparison is how much effect Kimbrough's running has had for the Western Michigan team, and that has been big here in the second half.
First down. Ooh, look at him go. It almost seems like they're dropping off from blitzing so many people because they're out rushing him.
Yeah, now it's a matter of contain Kimbrough. They can't continue to go to that point 7-8 yards behind the line of scrimmage and hope to hit him because he's not there. That's what the quarterback draw has been doing for Western Michigan, and they've done it successfully here in the second half. Kimbrough did not want to run that ball, but Ajima, his receiver, fell down right in front of the Bronco bench, and he was left to have to run that ball.
Fresno State leads by 11. 1 minute remaining in the third quarter. Oh, great defense. Willie Howard, Nick Ruggieroli.
Just collapsing the entire left side of the line for Western Michigan. Not often today has that offensive line crumbled. You know, they average over 275 pounds up there, the big guys up front for Western Michigan. But they were no match that time for Willie Howard and his pals.
From the 44, third and 11. And the defense taking a seat. Well, they need a breather. They've been on the field a lot in the second half. Rest of the team on their feet. On the reverse. Alan Boyko. Kimbrough steps up and throws it long, but it's incomplete for Bruce Boyko. The razzle-dazzle does not work, and Bill Stein comes in to punt the ball away. Ruggieroli and Ron Cox were in the face of Tony Kimbrough, and now he's limping off.
Hey, he's taken some shots. He's had to run the ball today. He's trying to get down on the ground. He's taken a beating. But again, he is the man for Western Michigan's offense. Dave Cruz is a fine quarterback, a big tall kid, the backup. But Tony Kimbrough adds something that Cruz can't give to this team, and that's the mobility and leadership.
Let's see if they go for the block or go for the return. Looks like they're going for the return. Alexander, he scored two touchdowns already. From the eight, the wall is set up. Nice return, and there's the flag. It had to happen.
Another flag.
That's the end of the third quarter, and we'll come back with our score. Fresno State 35, Broncos 24.
Honey?
Douglas is going away to camp.
So?
So who's going to program the VCR?
Panasonic understands. So this VCR is as simple to program as drawing a line. This Panasonic shows you what to do on screen. You can even use a phone to program this VCR.
My parents don't need me anymore.
They got a Panasonic VCR too, huh?
If it's Panasonic, it's easy to program.
My mom's going to Tokyo on business.
Tokyo, where's that?
About a million miles away.
Wow, she better bring a sweater.
Every day, Northwest flies from more of the U.S. to more of Asia than any other airline.
You just got a frequent flyer award, huh?
That's right.
You don't fly frequently.
No, infrequently.
How can you be a frequent flyer if you don't fly frequently?
How can I hit the ball if you're talking
to
me?
How can you hit the ball if you're going to be talking over there?
On Northwest, you don't have to fly a lot to earn a free trip fast.
Hi, am I glad you're here? You know, they figured out Cinemax has around 130 different movies a month. That's big movies, exciting movies, funny movies. Now, Showtime, on the other hand, has half as many. How are they able to do that? Does Showtime call up and go, excuse me, can we have a month that has less days in it, please? No, I'll tell you how they do it. They show more repeats. They show the same movies over and over again, and there's nothing you can do about it. You can't say, please show me another movie. Please, I know all the dialogue to this movie.
Times like this, now you can choose this. New Maximum Strength Pepto-Bismol. Now there's twice the medicine, twice the Pepto.
It's Bowl Week on ESPN. The All-American Bowl featuring the Florida Gators against the Fighting Illini. The SeaWorld Holiday Bowl with Heisman Trophy winner Barry Sanders leading Oklahoma State against high-scoring WAC champion Wyoming. And the Mazda Gator Bowl, a showdown between Georgia and Michigan State in the only bowl game on New Year's Day. It's a bowl bonanza, live on ESPN.
There's your score by quarters. Western Michigan led at halftime 17-14, but Fresno State with a huge third quarter.
What's significant about that is that Fresno State is notoriously a fast starter. Started slow in this game, but 21 points in that third quarter.
Well, after the clip, Andre Alexander's punt return, and a fine one it was, is brought back. Barscotti dumps it off. Nice run. Another flag. And what else is new? Well, ESPN has plenty of good bowl games on this holiday season. We've got this football game right here at the California Bowl. And it is number 8. Holding against the offense. They also have the Gator Bowl and the All-American Bowl coming your way on ESPN.
Jim Sweeney saying, just let me get through the California Bowl in one piece, and I'll worry about all the other ones. You have 18 penalties for Fresno State. A good run by Rosette wiped out there.
We also have the Holiday Bowl coming your way on ESPN. And there's the Red Wave. They're still sticking around. Jim Sweeney was upset with them a couple of years ago when they left at halftime to watch the games on TV. He criticized for that, and he was criticized in the newspapers. It's 1st and 15. Nice run by Daryl Rosette. And what happened because of that, Steve, was the fans countered with some comedy.
Yeah, they did. They issued a couple of tickets. They issued the ticket to get into the football game and a permission slip to leave the stadium signed by Coach Sweeney. You know, it's a no-win situation sometimes when you're a head coach. You put a winning program in a stadium, you boost your attendance to 30,000, and then when you win by 25 points, fans leave before the end of the game.
Beautiful country here. Dump it off again, this time with Dwight Pickens. Nice move, 20-yard line. They'll be shy of a first down by a good 5-6 yards. It's third down. This is a great area to recruit to. The Yosemite National Park, one of the most spectacular areas of the country, is just an hour away, and you've got the Pacific Ocean to the west.
When we talk about bowls and how much fun they are, and the players all have a good time, and the fans, the city has a great time as well. They put on their best face. Fresno really looks forward to hosting this bowl every year, luncheons and banquets and what have you. And we've been treated very nicely by all the folks here in Fresno and the California Bowl people, and we appreciate our stay here.
We have 13:20 to play. Barsotti to the air. Incomplete and caught, but by who? It's near a first down. Myron Jones after it was tipped by a defensive lineman.
Nice
Mark
bit
DeBosny.
Nice bit of heads-up play there by Jones. who is kind of in the middle of everything, helping block. Watch the fake. Now Barsotti throws. You know, you don't see many passes by Barsotti knocked down because he's a big, tall kid. He generally throws over a lot of them. But Nabosny reaches his big hands up there from Western Michigan and knocks it right back into the face of the running back, Myron Jones.
Now decision time for Jim Sweeney. He is a gambler, but he says, with an 11-point lead, he says, we better punt that ball away. Al Moldy doesn't want ESPN to see the signals. Overparlighted will be punting it to Paul Ajima. High snap. Line drive punt. And out of bounds. Not a good kick by Overparlighted. So Western Michigan will take over down by 11 with 12:50 to play. And our score, Fresno State 35. Western Michigan, 24.
We're not a company.
But outstanding people come to us every day.
People who want to make a contribution to a team and do work that really counts.
People eager to see new places, do the unusual, and find the unusual.
People who become your friends for life. People just like you.
We're not a company.
We're your country.
We're the Navy.
The Air Force.
The Marines.
The Army.
We're the armed forces.
It's a great place to start.
All airplanes are created equal, built by the same people. But after they're built, something happens. People don't think of all airlines in the same way. Just look at all the business flyers that have flown with us over the years. Maybe it's that we fly to more business centers. Or maybe it's how we fly to more business centers. United. Rededicated to giving you the service you deserve. Come fly the friendly skies.
horses give Comanche so much power, but it's the name Jeep that gives it so much pull.
Save up to $1,700 on select 1989 Jeep Comanches.
Fresno State enjoying an 11-point lead, 35-24 over Western Michigan. The 1988 California Bowl is brought to you by the U.S. Armed Forces. It's a great place to start by United. Rededicated to giving you the service you deserve. Come fly the friendly skies. And by Jeep. There's a feeling you can get only in a Jeep. We have 12 minutes and 50 seconds left in the ball game. 35-24 our score. Bulldogs with the advantage. And Kimbrell has 56 yards to go to try and pull him a little closer, and he has a lot more to go now after Ruggeroli's sack.
Nick Ruggeroli with his own version of the sack dance. And once again, he better be careful because that's going to get a flag for taunting if he's not. Big play by Ruggeroli, the sophomore out of Las Vegas. Not very big, but oh, so quick. And look at him run right between two blockers and make the play. Kimbrough couldn't even get back and get set up to throw.
Loss of 8, second down, 18. Double slot on the left side. Kimbrough may be changing up, and he is. He's checking off. Fresno State with a different defense. Uh-oh. Third down and a mile. Jeff Thiessen with the heat on Kimbrough. He's only a freshman. He will be the young man. Oh, no, that's Tracy Rogers again. Thiessen will be the guy who will replace Rogers in the future. This is what's happened when they have been able to pressure Kimbrough.
And it hasn't been all that much, at least down to the second half. But, oh, has the Fresno State defense come alive? Whatever the speech was at halftime worked. 4 sacks on the day. They blocked a pass. And the hurries, ever so important, 8 hurries, forcing Kimbrough to get rid of that ball before he wants to.
And that's why she's smiling right now, because her Bulldogs are leading Tony Kimbrough's Broncos by 11 with 12 minutes left in the game. Nice catch, but shy of a first down. David Bell comes up with it. Coming up next on ESPN, we'll be going to Bob Carpenter, who's at the LSU Florida basketball game. And then later, after that Florida game is over, we will have Seton Hall, number 20 in the nation, against St. John's in the Big East opener for both schools. Right now, LSU has a 1-point edge on Florida. Stein with the punt. Alexander with the fair catch at the 15-yard line. And it's first and 10 for Barsotti. And you know they'll be putting that ball on the ground now. Work the clock with the 11-point lead and 11 minutes to play.
Well, that's something that they've wanted to do all day here. And they have successfully done all season long. And that's run the ball. It's something that you can't do at a program until you get in and get established, as Al Moldy was telling us.
Look at Haberding. Is he exhausted?
Oh, he's got to be tired. I mean, he's been out there working hard, trying to stay with those fast, big guys from Fresno State. Rogers and Cox, those guys coming off the corners all day, they make those big offensive linemen work hard. And at about 275 pounds, Haberdink is one tired kid right now.
Bartleski goes in motion. Rosette. Another good gain across the 20-yard line. They need to get to the 25 for a first down. Paul DeVries, as the clock winds inside of 11 minutes left.
You know, the players here every year go visit the Children's Hospital here in Fresno, along with all of the folks in town, the great, great institution. And these players really are moved by what they see there. We'll talk more about some of those kids in just a minute.
Barsotti with the inside flipping handoff to Darrell Set for a short gain. You saw Kevin Haberding. And what a great competitor he has been. He's limping now. And that right leg was broken after the 7th game. He came back 2 games later. One of the most courageous players, well, not only in the MAC conference, but in all of America this year. It's his final season, and he wants to play football. A lot of NFL scouts are eyeing him. Third down and 3. Play action, but Barsotti is sacked at the 11-yard line. Terry Crews would not buy that fake toss by Barsotti and wrapped him up.
You know, Steve, you were mentioning a moment ago Kevin Haberdink, the big offensive tackle. He won an award here that's presented every year at the California Bowl. The last several years, the Josh Bryant Award represents courage on behalf of a player for each team. And the courage and fortitude shown by Kevin Haberdink got him the Josh Bryant Award, a little boy who died of leukemia at that hospital, but who was ever so impressed with the football players and made a real contribution to this game.
I don't know. What are you gonna do?
I don't know.
I'd go to college.
Me too.
If I had the money.
Yeah.
So what are you gonna do?
I don't know. What are you gonna do?
You don't want those fries.
What are you gonna do, Jack? Eat your way to college?
Really?
I'm going to college. On the new GI Bill, you serve full-time in the armed forces or part-time in the reserves, and you earn a lot of money for tuition.
The GI Bill.
Are you using that pickle?
For young men and women in the armed forces, it's a great place to start. See your local military recruiter.
The most powerful engine in its class. 4 doors, room for 5. Available 4-wheel anti-lock brakes. We've done our part in separating Jeep Cherokee from everything else. Now it's your turn.
Save up to $1,600 on select 1989 Jeep Cherokees.
Oh, Harold, it's lovely.
I hope you like it.
It reminds me of when we first got electric light back when I was a child.
Oh.
Daddy used to draw his chair up to that light and read to us.
Oh,
and memories. But Harold, this is the 80s. And I wanted a Bud Light.
If you want the one light that outshines them all, ask for Bud Light.
Kill the light, will you, Harold?
Oh, because everything else is just a light.
9 minutes, 11 seconds left in this football game. It's 35-24, Fresno State leading. Tony Kimbrough has 43 yards to go to try and pull his football team just a bit closer. Rodgers from the outside, and the pass is overthrown, and a flag is thrown.
Kimbrough took a nasty shot at Tracy Rodgers, and he having a couple of words. While they sort all that out, let's once again tell you about the Josh Bryant Award. Again, emblematic of courage on behalf of a player chosen from each football team. Josh Bryant, a little boy who died of leukemia at Valley Children's Hospital a couple of years back, got to be very good friends with Coach Sweeney and his son, Kevin Sweeney. The Josh Bryant Award winner for this year, Kevin Haverdink, the big offensive tackle for Western Michigan. And for Fresno State, Brian Greer. We've told both their stories, both coming back from injuries, both proving that you can come back if you work hard enough, and quite frankly, if you want to come back. And that's what these two young men have both done. Congratulations to them.
Meantime, on the field, Western Michigan was penalized 10 yards for holding, so it's a first and 20. So now from the 47-yard line. Kimbrough will keep one back in. Now Davis floats out there, and Kimbrough is sacked. Well, they're going backwards. Last time they went backwards, this time they're going backwards with penalties and sacks. Brian Greer was the man responsible for getting to Tony that time.
Our Josh Bryant Award winner fighting through. And now when Fresno State knows that the Broncos are going to have to throw virtually every play as if they haven't been coming hard enough the rest of the game, now they can really concentrate on rushing that passer. And again, when you've got guys like Greer and Ron Cox with his speed and Tracy Rodgers coming from the outside, not to mention a safety or two, they're going to make things awfully tough on Tony Kimbrough.
It really limits what you can do. And they need 31. Kimbrough needs him quickly. He's got his man over the middle. 50-yard line, Robert Oliver. 14 yards they make up. They need 17 now on third down.
You stick with what you do best. And Fresno State, even here in the late going, knowing that the pass is coming at him, do you see him in a prevent defense? No way. These Bulldogs, they play that man-to-man coverage, and they're going to stay with it.
Steve, are we approaching four down time inside of 8 minutes left?
Oh, I think so. At 11 points down, I believe you have to be thinking in that way. And Al Mulde's offense, they can pick up 11, 12, 15, 20 yards a pop with this passing game. He's got confidence in it.
Again, the crowd rising to the occasion. Overthrown, it's fourth down, 16 yards to go. Ajima was the intended man.
I think Coach Mulde thought about it for a moment on the sidelines and then said, well, let's let our kicker come on one more time and we'll try to punt them down deep in their own territory and get the ball back. Look at Kevin Haverdink limping off the field, that big guy with all those bandages on that leg that he broke. What a tough competitor he is.
Hey, this has been a very, very proud season for Western Michigan. Regardless of what they do, what Al Mulde has done at Western Michigan, well, Fresno State blocks a punt. Andre Alexander goes to recover it. Instead, it's picked up by a Western. What Andre Alexander was doing near it, I don't know.
Hello, I'm Art Stanton. In the world of office equipment, copy machines, computer typewriters, and facsimile machines, everything's always changing with new technology and new levels of production. But in another way, at Stanton Office Machines, we believe some things should never change. Quality, service, and dependability. For over 32 years now, It's been the same simple, straightforward approach. So when you're looking for new office machines, call and ask to see the newest from one of the oldest, Stanton Office Machines.
The last month of the year at Klassen Honda is the best time of the year for you to get the buy of the year. We've received a one-time-only allocation of extra Civics, CRXs, Preludes, and Accords. Take delivery of the Honda of your choice today. Just $89 delivers. In celebration of the season, Klassen Honda Subaru will donate $25 for each car, new or used, to Special Olympics. Klassen Honda, first on price, first in customer satisfaction. On North Blackstone, south of Sierra, Fresno.
ESPN is your ticket to the NFL when the Broncos and Seahawks go edge-to-head. Top Gun John Elway leads Denver's drive toward another division title for the defending AFC champion. The Seahawks will try to bust the Broncos with a playoff spot at stake in the wild AFC West showdown. ESPN's all-pro team of Mike Patrick and Joe Theismann bring you all the action of NFL Sunday Night Football live on ESPN.
Great game tomorrow on ESPN in the NFL. We have a terrific showcase here at the California Bowl at Fresno State. Western Michigan led at halftime 17-14. They led 24-21, but Jim Sweeney's Bulldogs have come back, and now it's the Broncos' turn to try and rally. And at the end of that change of possessions, Andre Alexander almost made a huge mistake on the punt return. But they leave the football in Fresno State's hands. Barsotti will give it to Reset. Big hole off the left side, a gain of three before Barrios wraps him up. He closed that hole quickly.
Well, he's the number two tackler on this ball club. Good football player. There's the total yardage. Again, both teams over 400 yards. They both averaged over 400 yards during the regular part of their season.
Let's see, 855 yards. You take away the 200 yards in penalties, so they're down to 655.
That's right. And now you wonder why the game has gone 4 hours. These two teams can really move this ball up and down the field.
And Bob Carpenter is still waiting for us to hand it to him for the LSU-Florida game. Rosette, first down. DeVries and Berrios in the tackle. And Darryl Rosette having his second highest rushing total in his career. He had 148 earlier this year. He has 132 on 18 carries now.
You know, it was tough on him when he came here to Fresno State because with Skipper in front of him, you know Clyde Skipper is going to get the majority of the action. However, Darryl Rosette has been biding his time, and now when he gets the opportunity, he's done a fine job.
It's first down. Inside of 6:20 left now. Ooh, it looked like the left side was trying to call a timeout. Well, let's now go to John Saunders with the Panasonic video replay.
Thank you, gentlemen. Our Panasonic video replay came in the second quarter of today's Division II championship game. Game tied at 7. North Dakota State's Tony Satter takes the pitch around the left end, makes a couple of nice moves, and he's off. Satter ran for 151 yards and two touchdowns. Another nice move right there around the 25, and North Dakota State defeats Portland State 35-21 for the Division II national championship, their fourth in the last 6 years. Let's go back to Steve Rabel and Steve Fizziak.
North Dakota State doing it again. They seem to be the year in, year out. Willie Berrios on the tackle. And again, Fresno State trying to wind that clock down. It will be inside of 6 minutes when this next play comes off.
Portland State, I remember a few years back when they had a kid named Neil Lomax playing quarterback up there in a run-and-shoot offense of Mouse Davis that nobody could stop. Portland State getting all the way to the championships there and losing today. What a run by that kid, huh?
Second down, 11 yards to go. Oh, they read that into play nicely by Darryl Rosette.
Eric Hoffman came from inside to make that play, and from the outside, Paul DeVries, the outside linebacker, who was a defensive back during spring drills. They moved him over to outside linebacker. He's not very big, but he gets upfield to make the plays in a hurry.
Now from the 44, it's third and 11. Let's see if they keep it on the ground. No, Barsotti's going up top, and he's going for the home run, but his man is not there. Dwight Pickens got crossed up at the line of scrimmage and rerouted by the defensive back. So it's fourth down and 11.
Pickens broke to the post. I think Barsotti was figuring he was going to come out of that break heading straight upfield. Receivers and quarterbacks always have to be on the same page. That's another one of those nice cliches we like to use. All it means is they have to both see the same coverage, and the receiver has to know the quarterback is going to throw the ball deep against a certain coverage and maybe throw a post against a different coverage.
Over par lighter. Ajima will take it. Nice return, 37-yard line. 16 yards on the return after the 36-yard punt by Oberparleiter. 4 minutes, 54 seconds remaining in this ball game. Fresno State leading by 11, 35-24.
And the Broncos, who haven't had a whole lot going here in the second half, are going to have to dig down into that bag of tricks now and come up with a couple of big plays. Look for perhaps the backs flaring out or crossing, because Fresno State's going to stick with this man-to-man coverage in the secondary.
Kimbrough going deep. Oliver not there. Pass too high. And it's second down and 10.
Darrell Martin doing something he didn't do much of in the first half, and that's actually get his hands on Oliver, the wide receiver, and push him off his route just a little bit. Slow him down. Tony Kimbrough just couldn't pick up the angle at which his receiver was going to be breaking. Threw the ball too far.
4 minutes, 48 seconds remaining. Kimbrough facing a second and 10. We'll have no backs there. And here comes the outside rush. Too hard was the pass to Bruce Boyko. It's third down and 10.
Bruce Boyko doesn't normally drop a pass, but then again, when you're in this situation and you're a little bit frustrated, Tony Kimbrough had about, he had way too much heat on that pass. No way he should have thrown that ball that hard. Just make the completion at this point. You got to get something, anything going.
Al Moldy needs some help. Coming up next, we've got college basketball, LSU and Florida. Last time we checked, LSU is leading by 1 point. Kimbrough needs a big one. It's third and 10. He has time. Now it's closing. Incomplete. It's fourth and 10. Alan Boyko is the target. Well, great secondary coverage that time.
Tell you who else was the target. Number 11 right there. Tony Kimbrough was the target of one Ryan Cox, number 54, who was charging hard that time. Tracy Rogers, 45, is being blocked, and nicely by Haverdink. But watch, you can't hold the ball that long. Oh, does he take a shot in the ribs from Ryan Cox.
Stein to Alexander. Ooh, Andre better go get it. Escapes one man, but not another, and that's a 45-yard punt by Billy Stein. 4.5 minutes to play. It's 35-24. Bulldogs leading the Broncos.
Alexander took an earful from his coach a couple of moments ago for getting close to a punt that was bouncing around. But as a punt returner, I mean, you've got to have a little bit of leeway out there, and you have to know that if that ball gets close to you, you see it rolling around. If there's nobody around, you pick it up. Maybe you can pick up some yardage. But by all means, if it's surrounded by defenders, stay away from it.
Fresno State, I'm sure, three running plays. Yeah, right, Steve. Anthony Williams.
I guarantee you that's what Al Moldy and his defense were thinking. Well, Fresno's going to come out and try to run this one out. Barsotti, first shot out of the box, comes out and puts up a 5-yard quick out pass. Earlier this season, we saw Fresno State here on ESPN beat Utah State by a wide score. A lot of folks were asking me after the game, why did Fresno State keep throwing late in the game when they were up by 35-40 points? Because that's what they do best. They do it all the time, so they just kept putting the ball up.
Oh, and they're near a first down. It's Darryl Rosette again.
It has nothing to do with
most valuable player.
Yeah, it has nothing to do with running the score up at that point. You're just going along by the game plan.
Clock winding down inside. 3.5 minutes left. Fresno State trying for their third California Bowl victory. And that would be a record. Third down, short two, Rosette gets it. First and 10, Fresno State. And you know, Jim Sweeney is over on that Fresno State sideline, and he is looking for career win number 143. And when he was a young coach at Montana State, well, he worshiped. Coach Bear Bryant at Alabama used to go down and listen to him speak, and he went to see him speak when he was young. He still has a little book he took notes on 28 years ago and keeps it in the top drawer of his desk. It's a great quote on the first page. It says, "You should only coach if you can't live without it." And Jim Sweeney is doing a wonderful job in this football game. 2:46 remaining in this ball game. It's 35-24. Fresno State leading. Let's go to Bob Carpenter at the Florida LSU game.
All right, thank you, Steve Fizziak and Steve Rabel with Bill Raftery. This is Bob Carpenter at the O'Connell Center in Gainesville, Florida. 7:14 left, first half. The LSU Tigers coach have been outstanding tonight, and Chris Jackson at the line has now scored his 13th point of the night. Ricky Blanton already has 17.
Efficient on offense. This is one of the great freshmen in the country. Of course, everybody who follows basketball, Blanton has been sensational during his career at LSU, and they just can't buy a basket. The other end, Florida, doing a pretty good job against the press. It's just not shooting well.
Look at that score. 41-17. The Gators can't hit any easy shots. And now we'll send you back to the California Bowl out in Fresno. Back to Steve Fizziak and Steve Rabel.
Thanks, Bob. Last time we checked, it was a one-point ball game. Now they're blowing them out 41-17. Well, here we've got a 35-24 Fresno State leading. Almost a two-minute warning. Barsotti will call time. He did not like what he saw. And with 2:11 left, it's an 11-point Fresno State lead.
We're not a company, but no company has more pride in what they do, or more pride in how well they do it. We offer you a meaningful and fulfilling future, one that goes far beyond the ordinary, one that brings with it the respect and admiration of Americans everywhere. We're not a company, we're your country. We're the Air Force, the Marines, the Army, the Navy. We're the Armed Forces. It's a great place to start.
First, my dog ran away. So to cheer myself up, I bought an expensive TV, and it came with a remote. Then my girlfriend left me, so I bought a VCR, and it came with a remote. Then I was transferred to the Yukon Territory, and it came with a remote. Then I was audited by the IRS, and they came with remotes. So to simplify my life, I bought a Memorex CP8 Universal Remote, which could do everything 8 different remotes could do. Then I was happy. In fact, the happiest cold and lonely guy stuck in the Yukon without a dog.
All right, stand by. Replay on Slim-O A. Roll A and dissolved A. Good.
Roll C. Wipe C.
Let's get white and out on camera 8 over there. Nod so I know you're there, somebody. Ready, D.
Get back to the coach on that.
Okay, let's go to camera 5, please. White and out. Ready, camera 8. Take 8.
I didn't know your family was in town.
Go to camera 2. Nice work, people. Very nice work.
For the teamwork, the clean, crisp taste of Beechwood-aged Budweiser.
So what are you going to do tonight?
Probably watch TV.
United Airlines, from the ground up, rededicated to giving you the service you deserve. Come fly the friendly skies.
2 minutes, 11 seconds remaining. Barsotti with the option play. Darrell was set for just, if he got anything, he's lucky. Third down, but Rosette has been the story in this football game. 2 touchdowns. He has gained 149 yards, and that is a career high. Western Michigan, meantime, with 322 through the air, but Fresno State capitalizing on turnovers.
They're the storyline of this ball game up to this point. Davis with a 51-yard touchdown run for Western Michigan. Really, Western Michigan has done virtually nothing here in the second half.
It started out well, and Fresno State just came roaring back.
Credit Fresno State's defense with that, because they were giving up yardage at big chunks there for a while until they finally solidified that defensive group.
Lance Overparleiter looking in for his 8th punt. We had an incredible amount of possessions in the first half. Each team had 12 opportunities for an offensive possession. Fresno State has 19 now. Western Michigan has 20. They go for the block. It's not there. Ajima with the fair catch near the 31-yard line. So Fresno State leading by 11 with inside 1:56 now left in this football game. And we'll be joining Bob Carpenter very shortly for that LSU-Florida game, which was a blowout when we checked with it in the first half. 41-17 last time we talked to Bob, and LSU was leading Florida. And there's a good look at Al Moldy, who's come a long way in his career. He was at Sioux Falls College, and he remembered playing Yankton College, getting beat by 69-0. And in the second half, the officials coming over and saying, hey, coach, would you mind if we let the clock run, even on passing completions? He said, let her run, let's get out of
here.
That's
right, let her run.
He'll stop it here. He still has a chance. Stranger things have happened. Kimbrough rolling out. He escapes McCutcheon, but he cannot escape Ron Cox.
I don't know that anybody all season long has escaped Ron Cox. He closes as fast as any linebacker I've seen play this year. Kimbrough is going to be one tired, sore football player when this game is over.
Kim will be joining Dale Brown's LSU Tigers, Norm Sloan in Florida. Bob Carpenter and Bill Raftery coming your way very soon. 1:45 left in this ball game. 35-24. Kimbrough needs to end with the first down situation. Incomplete. Clock stops at 1:41. Boyko will argue. Yeah, they're calling them champions right now. And they have been champions of the MAC. Kalamazoo.
Kimbrough looking back to the sidelines now, looking to his coach, Al Moldy. This is his system. He's developed a system over the years. We asked him who he admired, who he looked up to as a coach. He said, you know, I've watched a lot of coaches, but this is the system I've come up with, and it's been successful for me, so I don't wear it on my sleeve, but I think anybody else is so terrific.
On second down. The pass is complete at the 50-yard line. They'll say he came back, went out of bounds at the 49. They must get inside the 47 in Fresno State territory for a first down. So it'll be third down, about four. Page him on the catch. And they'll go with that hurry-up offense with the clock showing 1:20 and counting. They say he did not go out of bounds. He went to one knee, so Kimbrough goes right back to work. Downfield. Catch is made. Alan Boyko.
And that's not just any catch. That is an excellent catch by Boyko, reaching way up in the air for a tough pass thrown very hard by Tony Kimbrough. We're looking right now at one of the MVPs in this football game, Tony Kimbrough.
Courageous effort in the face of a tremendous rush. Down the field, completes the pass. Robert Oliver still carrying would-be tacklers to the 24-yard line. 55 seconds, they stop the clock. And they have one timeout left, Fresno State with two. Oliver goes wide left. Martin will cover him. The secondary dropping off just a bit more. Kimbrough down the field. Pass is complete. First down again. Alan Boyko again.
Another good pass and catch under pressure. Once again, those big offensive linemen. Look at Kevin Haverday. Look at the bandages on that left leg. He's so tired he can hardly stand up. Yet he drags himself back after pass protecting for his quarterback. Gets himself to that line of scrimmage.
Well, you don't think NFL scouts are watching him, watching the heart that he has shown today. 35-24. Fresno State up. Kimbrough will roll out away from Garnett Fountain. The pass, though, is complete at the 5-yard line. And a flag is down at that point. Age him on the catch. Jeff White on the coverage. 28 seconds remaining.
I think Tony Harris here toward the near sideline may have gotten into it a little bit with one of the receivers from Western Michigan. Flag was thrown away from the play. away from the pass reception.
Holding on the defense. So it'll be second down. No, this will be an automatic first down, excuse me. Well, I've just been handed the California Bowl Most Valuable Players. For Western Michigan, Tony Kimbrough, who has turned in an excellent performance today. And for Fresno State, Daryl Rosette, number 22, coming off the bench and scoring two touchdowns and running for almost 150 yards. Crowd on their feet, and they're from Kalamazoo. He has his man, Rob Davis, but he can't hold on. And the clock stops at 22 seconds left in the first and goal.
I think Rob Davis was hearing number 7, Craig Bowens, tiptoeing up to stick one right in his ear hole, which he did. The thing is, if you're going to get out there and get hit like that, you might as well catch the pass. You're going to take the shot anyway.
So we have 22 seconds left. Kimbrough, who's thrown for 362 yards already, his high game this year is 381.
In fact, he had three of the top five passing games in the MAC conference this year. Some kind of quarterback.
That's why he was the MAC's offensive player of the year. So first and goal from, or excuse me, second and goal from the 6. Kimbrough on the draw will score the touchdown. And hey, they still have a chance. They already have recovered one onside kick, and they have pulled to within 4. 17 seconds left.
This play has worked for them the entire second half. Understandable why they go back to it again, the quarterback draw. Wait for that inside to open up and let the big guys escort you in. And that's exactly what Tony Kimbrough did.
Boy, Ray Fonseca really got the linebacker out of the picture to enable that draw play to work.
Kevin Haverdink had a pretty good block on that as well. In fact, he was forced to jump over somebody and dragging all those pads. It was really difficult. Now going for 2 is Western Michigan.
So now they'll try and pull within 3. Loops it in the end zone. It's incomplete. Now they must get the touchdown. Either way, they had to score the touchdown to win. A field goal, had they made that 2-pointer, they would have been able to tie. You know, it's an interesting story about championships. It's like the Los Angeles Dodgers beating the Oakland A's this year. Who are the heroes in the game? Of course, Oral Hershiser, but you had guys like Mickey Hatcher who came in off the bench and hit home runs for you. Haverdink has done a wonderful job for Western Michigan, an offensive lineman who's shown great courage not only in this game but throughout this year, coming back after breaking a leg. 2 games later, he was in the lineup. And for Fresno State, a man off the bench, Daryl Rosette, when Kelly Skipper, the senior leader, left the lineup, Rosette comes in. He gains 148 yards. He rushes for 2 touchdowns. He's one of the most valuable players. So too is number 11, Tony Kimbrough.
Tony Kimbrough, a kid off the streets of Detroit, in his own words, said, "If it hadn't been for my grandmother, I'd probably be back there with those friends I ran with on the streets of Detroit." And a lot of those kids, he said, are either dead or in jail or on drugs.
Well, he is a great success story. So too that man today. He has tied his career high of 148 yards, and he has a chance to break it here if they recover and run the ball. Here we will see John Creek, who has been successful on an onside kick already once in this game. He sends everybody over to the left side. And there is the return. A scramble for it. And Fresno State has recovered. So Jim Sweeney on the sideline breathing a sigh of relief as the young freshman Robinson comes away with the football with 14 seconds showing on the clock.
You could not ask for a better kick from John Creek from Western Michigan. You kick that short hopper and then try to get it to bounce over the first line of defenders. Western Michigan could not get their hands on the ball.
Mark Barsotti will probably go to one knee. The Broncos have but one timeout left. Ball at midfield. And they'll have a 1 setback way behind everybody. Barsotti says, "I'm out of here." The clock ticking to 11. They'll call timeout one last time, and then the game is over.
Here comes Coach Sweeney as he walks across the field. He didn't know that Western Michigan had called timeout. He was all set to come over and accept some congratulations.
And he gets a hug. One of the assistant coaches on the sideline.
You know that Jim Sweeney, when we talked to him in his office yesterday, he can be kind of loud and he can be sort of aggressive and want to slap hands and high fives. But when we mentioned, and he told us the story about his team dedicating this season to his late wife, Seal, who passed away just a year ago, it brought tears to that man's eyes, Jim Sweeney.
Well, the football team got themselves together, and you might see a black stripe down the middle of their helmets. They have dedicated this football season to the wife, Seal. I'm sure when this game is over, he will look to the heavens, and as he said so many times this year, she has the best seat in the house, and she has a proud moment this evening in Fresno, California.
She's seen a great game out here, as have we all. What an offensive show by both these football teams.
And that will do it. They count them down in Fresno, California, the champions of the California Bowl in this eighth annual game. Jim Sweeney is brought to his players' shoulders. He's the champion. Victory number 143 in his major